Srácok, én nyomatok erről egy felvételt, mert most hát lesz egy kis event várás mindenféleképpen. És itt közben bezárom a cuccokat, mert ezekre nem kemény szükségem. Pillanat, csak erre mondják azt, hogy a élő show varázsa.
Just like, oh, we want to go fast, Alan. And I'm like, yeah.
Yeah, you gotta go fast. Oh, Rich is out to a command.
Na, gyerekek, most már...
Yeah, got a lot of points up there. I don't understand what's going on.
A Uplay most már rip. Meghalt a Szero? Elhiszem. Nem csodálom amúgy. Tehát ez várható volt. Amúgy is szarok a szerverek, de olyan szinten, hogyha így felpörgették ezt...
Sorry, Fred. I see you.
There we go.
I'm not too worried, though, because...
Megpusztult a Uplay. Akkor még időbe léptünk ki, ugye? Akkor még időbe léptünk ki. És most ezt fogjuk nézni egy órán keresztül, ahogy Chris, meg Belinda, meg Fred, meg Richard nyomatják a Trackmániát. Vagy mi lesz ezzel? Meg amik még lesznek, aha. A régi verzióját mondtátok, hogy az nagyon menő volt, és hogy megint olvasom azt a szöveget, hogy ez már nem az a játék, ami régen volt, majd a Trackmania. Én az egyel se játszottam, vagy ez most nem tudom a hanyadik rész, de én nem játszottam ezekkel. Bármiről is lehet dumálni, gyerekek, bármiről is. Az én kérdésem az, hogy ti mit vártok a legjobban? Melyik game-re vagytok a legjobban kíváncsiak? Az Uborka Softnál. Nem, remélem, ezek jók szoktak lenni. Tavaly, még amikor Angliában voltam kint, és ott volt az ilyen különböző eventek. Jó, hát az E3-at azt hagyjuk, mert most nem az E3-at, az EA Games azt hagyjuk, mert az Apex-el kicsit kicsapták a biztosítékot, az elég vicces volt, de hagyjuk is. Amúgy tök jó közben beszélgetni, megnézni az ilyen trailereket. AC Valhalla, Cyberpunk, legjobb Johnny. Én is a Cyberpunkot várom a legjobban a Ubisoft. Hát, ha kiadják. Szóval Sajder, szia! Még nem kezdtük el, vagyis még nem kezdtük el, majd beszólok a srácoknak, és majd utána a Jubi majd elkezdi, de nem, még van egy óra, 59 perc ott a számláló, és addig pedig nézhetjük ezt a négy csodálatos embert, úriembert, illetve hölgyet, ahogy csapatják a Trackmániát, illetve vannak ott a Creed, Assassin's Creed-es kódok, amiket elvileg be lehet váltani. De milyen komoly, hogy ez most akkor úgy néz ki, hogy ha valaki be tudja írni a Uplay kódot, akkor lesz egy Odyssey, AC Odyssey. Megpróbáltam beváltani a kódot, ami ott írogatnak, de mind használt. Hát, hogyha csak egy 2 másodperccel hamarabb látja valaki a streamet, akkor is be tudja írni, már az előny. Hát Bull azt mondja, hogy foglalt a kód. Egy kódot csak egyszer lehet beváltani szerintem. Ezek nem hiszem, hogy olyan kódok, hogy bárki beválthatja. Körítés. Az AC nekem már halott kategória, csak a történelmi körítés érdekel mindenkit. Aha. Szia Csipesztó, szia. Én azt nem értem meg. Szia Ajni, köszi még egyszer a hostot. Azt nem értem meg, amikor azt mondják, hogy ez már nem az az AC, ami volt. Tehát persze, hogy már nem az az AC, ami volt. Tehát, hogyha abban maradtunk volna, ahogy Altairral vagy Ezióval éppen sétálgatunk fel alá az utcán, nem hiszem, hogy sokáig lett volna AC széria sorozat. Szépen fejlődött a játék, szépen fejlődött a harc technika, a grafika is. Játékmenet is. Én úgy gondolom, hogy tehát Most minek írják át a címét? Minek legyen egy újabb kategória? Hát de most minek írják át? Legyen az Pista Bálkalandjai 1, aztán Pista Bálkalandjai 2. Vagy különálló, mit tudom én, nem tudom ki lesz a karakter a Valhallában, annak a karakternek a neve. Sokan úgy hiszik, de ez mond a fő AC, pedig szerintem nem minden AC. Ez tény is, hogy valójában Revelation-nel fejeződött be, azzal zárult le egy korszak. Utána jött egy nagyon kis csúnya rész, ami az AC3 volt, azt én így fúj, felejtsük el, de kellett az AC3 is, mert olyan újításokat hoztak, ami akkor szar volt, de utána kijavították és jól működött a Black Flag-ben. Szia Meta, szia! Igen, ez értelmezés kell, abszolút. Nekem az AC az még mindig kicsit így a lopakodás, ninjázás, súranás, ez a Hidden Blade kategória. És mindegyikben benne volt. Meg talán ebbe is belehozták, és talán ebbe is belekötöttek, meg hogy most nem sólyom lesz, hanem varjú. Hát úristen. Hidden fejsze. Nem lesz Blade, csak nem lesz elrejtve. Ha jól tudom, nem lesz elrejtve a penge. Nem tudom, én örülök neki. Ez ugyanaz, mint az Odádból. Kijött már 14-15 évad, de még mindig, ahogy van, meg tudok nézni egy évadot belőle, mert szeretem. Itt inkább azoknak kedveskednek, akik tényleg a nagy AC fanok. Egy ilyen kérdésem lenne, kérésem, hogy esetleg be tudod linkelni a csatornát, amit nézel. Twitch-en beírod, hogy Ubisoft. Twitch-en beírod, hogy Ubisoft, és ott kidobja. Rétes tészta, azaz. Tilt, micsoda tilt. Alright folks, that's gonna bring our little let's play kind of competitive segment here to an end. I want to thank y'all for participating. Belinda. Nem hoztam be innivalót. De várj, most mi lesz? Most lesz valami. Jaj, be kéne hozni valami felnőttesebb italt. Szóval lehet, hogy szörpöt csinálok magamnak. Amúgy annak örülök, hogy most nincs meleg. Ha tegnap előtt lett volna a Ubisoftnak a live-ja, akkor megkattanok. Igyá! Na most kíváncsi leszek, mi lesz? Most lesz valami. Nem, tudjátok, hogy teját szoktam inni. Mindig teját szoktam behozni. Amikor LEGO stream volt, akkor is mindig teját ittam. Jó lenne már egy LEGO stream valamikor. Annyira leégtem, hogy most kezdem el. Most kezdél hámlok. Én is. Hámlok egy picit. Voltam kint a napon amúgy. Kimentem az erkélyre. És szerintem egy 10 percig voltam kint, és már megkaptam. Tehát már folyok szét. Akkor azt mondja, hogy 24 perc múlva lesz a Crew, Jazz Dance, meg ezek. Meta, köszönöm szépen a cheert, köszi a támogatást. Marci, köszi a hostot. Nem lehet olyan gyorsan beírni. Jaja. Fönt látjátok? Valaki próbálja meg beírni a Far Cry New Dawn-nak a kódját. Ott van fent. Hashtag Ubisoft Forward, azaz nyomassátok. Szerintem amúgy pont azért is vitték el más irányba egy idő után az AC-t, hogy ne legyen szablonos az egész. Hát azért mondom, hogy egy idő után unalmas lett volna az AC, az biztos. És nagyon durva akciók vannak az AC-nál. Megnézem, hogy betölti-e. Hogy meghal. Lehet meghal, várja. 4 nap kellett, úgyhogy kb. 0-21, az igen. Félkor, igen, Etenir, félkor. Jézusom, de tölti! Hát ez ne... Simán indul, hát én most nem akar simán indulni. Tölti még mindig, de... De ott van minden. BN Low, köszi a követést. Hát gyerekek, nálam nem simán megy. Nálam még szarakodik. Mindegy, megy a háttérbe, aztán majd ránézek, ha úgy van. Az odádból van egy rész, amit háromszor néztem meg, egyszer ugye alapból utána azért meg akartam nézni a barátnőmmel. Nem bír, majd közösen néztük, de mind a három alkalommal ugyanolyan figyelemmel kísérlet. Az tök jó hajni. Tegnap raktam össze egy kis Legót Obi-Wan kunyhóját szülinapomra, ami 24-én lesz, meglepem magam egy Roxford Express-szel. Na, helyes toxik. Helyes.
The player's not just sort of creating the map, they're also like, okay, I added a little bit, now I'm testing a little bit.
Á, nincs leterhelve. Na, srácok, akkor mindjárt jövök, jó, hozok valami itókát, meg szerintem a függöny most így be is húzom. Kaptok rá egy kis ubi hangot. Jó a kép, jó hang, ugye? Segítsetek, nem húztam fel teljesen, szándékosan, majd később, hogy jönnek a trailerek, akkor majd húzunk rajta egy picikét.
You know, to try to reproduce or to do better than him, so you can try every part of the game and get really good in really good map for the players.
Interesting. Okay, so when you're starting out, you know, obviously we're seeing someone with some map creation skills, but when players are starting out, you know, are there some tools to help them out? What do you recommend in terms of like, okay, when you're starting out, just try to make like a simple shape, or you know, try to just put in a sick jump, and that's good.
Yeah, well, in the free version of Trackmania, there is what we call a simple editor. So there is a simple editor and advanced editor. What we're seeing now is the advanced editor, so with all the tools, all the blocks. And the simple editor is like a best of blocks. So the blocks you need to do like a simple track, but a good one. You can at least make a good one. And I recommend to start with this, and then after you can get to the advanced editor and make crazy stuff like he's doing right now.
Nice. Now, is that advanced editor pretty akin to what the Trackmania team uses to create the actual tracks in the game?
Yeah, it's exactly the tool that we are using every day to make the track. We every tool we put in the game, we give it to the player as well, so they can make the same track as us.
Nice. So you can challenge people to beat you at your own game a little bit.
Yeah, and sometimes they're better than us. They do tracks that amaze us. I mean, I played some tracks that I always remember because it was so great.
Well, that's when you hire them for the team, right?
Yeah, it happened. We hire a lot. Well, the guy doing the video right now he used to be a player, and he's still a player, and now he's working with us. And we always have like pro players coming into the team and designers and level designers.
That's very cool. So, I mean, we're talking here about the Trackmania community then. You know, there are people out there going to be creating these tracks. If they're creating the tracks, they want people to race on them. How do they get folks in the seats, you know, to race on their track?
It's really simple with the next Trackmania, because now once you're done with your track, you can just put it out there on what we call a server review, a map review server, and they can, like, everybody can come up and test your tracks. They can rate your tracks. And when they rate it, they give it, for example, 5 stars. Afterwards, if your track is good for the players and we decide it's good, we're going to add it at what we call Track of the Day, which is like the front page of the game. And everyone is going to play it for sure. Every day there is a new track made by the players.
Nice. And so there is also that like server where can any player just kind of go in and be like, let me see what new creations people have today, and then rate them. So if that's your thing, if you're looking maybe for inspiration or just looking to try some wacky new tracks, that's a spot
can
go.
That's why I do. I always go to this server like every day and try new maps. Even if nobody's like pushing a map right now, there is always maps pushed earlier in the
earlier in the day, so you can. There's always tracks to test and new tracks to test. It's really great.
Nice. And so, if you get that, so you get your track in there, you get enough stars, get considered by the team, and you select them as a track of the day. Then you know people are racing it, and there's some incentives for people to get on that track as well, right?
Yeah, every day there will be a what we call a competition, a daily competition.
Hirtelen azt hittem, az én csetem pörög ennyire gyorsan, már majdnem megijedtem, hogy mi történt, de nem. Mi az a sok play? Hát szállam fel kellett, hogy a play, írjátok be, és play, és play. Most egy Division 2 kódot lehet nyerni, by the way. Hello mindenkinek, sziasztok srácok. Hát előleg 46 perc kezdésig, de félkor lesznek trailerek.
Global ranking of the game.
Talán.
Oh, nice. And speaking of competition, we are going to be seeing some of the top community racers.
Hogy pörög az a chat már? Hogy pörög az a chat?
Moments, folks, in our next segment. Right now we're talking with Augustin about.
Hoztam egy kis itókát, mármint akarom, hoztam teját jéggel, és jó behűtöttem. Szóval.
But there's also other creative outlets. I mean, you can.
Szóval egészségetekre.
For example, the livery on your car.
De még várok fel egy picit, mert nagyon hideg.
So you can create any skin you want with what we call a.
Meg van bolondulva, micsoda?
You can share it really easily with the world, within clubs. In just one click, you can find new skins that you like, and you can apply them.
Hiragit, Sukas, szia, köszönöm szépen a követés, bocsánat, csak kint voltam éppen, míg Quini, neked is szépen köszönöm a követés, sziasztok, hello mindenkinek, bocsánat, csak éppen kint voltam. Várunk, elég sokat várunk, mert azért kell, még sajnos egy 45 perc, mire elindul a mandula. Viszont engem tényleg nagyon érdekel, erről amúgy senki nem beszélt, és az mekkora meglepetés lenne, gyerekek, hogyha bejelentenének egy Beyond Good and Evil második részt, mármint, hogy most, majd kiadják idén, én nagyon örülnék neki. Az utolsó info arról a játékról talán tavalyi év végén jött, vagy év közepén, nem tudom. Van a Space Monkey nevezetű program, most ez hülyén hangzik, de van Space Monkey nevezetű Ubisoft program, amire én jelentkeztem, és elvileg az azt jelenti, hogy sokkal hamarabb megkapjuk az infókat, a szivárogtatásokat erről az egészről, de nem kaptunk semmit még. 16-17 éve várok, pontosan arra. Múltkor végig is játszottam, streamben azt a játékot. Vagy egy mobilos sprintelszel, pontosan. Na, az mennyire lenne? Szerintem a mobilos sprintelszel szállon az sokkal nagyobb végés lenne, mint az Apexnek az új DLC-je, vagy eventje, bocsánat, amire mondták, hogy ilyen különböző szörnyek lesznek. Az mennyire, azt emlékszem rá, hogy mennyire lelkesek voltatok ti is, amikor így bejelentették a Ubinál, hogy ez már pedig is lesz, bizony lesz. Én is hozok kóla tízesítéssel, na, Brevid, egészséged, de hozzad csak. Szeretem azt a fajta teját, helyes.
Well, there we have our completed track. Don't forget to save your tracks when you're creating them, folks. And we'll be taking a look at this. There's an autosave. Excellent. Yeah. Augustin, you put a lot of people's hearts to
ease just then. We'll be taking most a look at this track in action. Jól esik.
Augustin, before I let you go, I wanted to touch base on...
Amúgy ennek a játéknak mi a lényege? Valaki tudja? Valaki játszott a régi Trackmaniával? Nekem az Elosztoménia jutott róla eszembe, én azt hittem írtam, hogy egy motoros játékról beszélünk, de aztán láttam, hogy nem, hanem ilyen Forma 1-es kis versenyautókkal kell menni, ami körülbelül olyan, mint a... melyik, amivel távirányítós autókkal mész? Nem tudom pontosan rét. Vezes és légy, ennyi? Vezetni kell és elsőnek kell lenni. Abe, mi? Köszönöm szépen a követést, hello. Azaz, Revolt, azaz. Nem, ezekkel a játékokkal el lehet ideig, óráig feelingezni, de hosszú távon szerintem nem lehet ezekre építeni. Mármint például vannak bajnokságok belőle, tehát én azt sem tudtam volna tenni, hogy valaki ezeket nyomja orba szájba.
Well, it sounds like there's lots of tools for folks to get creative, to share those creations, to discover new stuff in addition to just...
A Revolt az jó. Nagyon szerettem. Emlékszem, a PC Guru mellé adták ki még annó. És amikor meg volt, és játszhattam vele, és úristen, milyen skinjeim voltak, hát imádtam. Csomó része van, tényleg?
Thank you for joining us and congrats.
Yeah, thank you. It's been great.
All right, folks. We've got some Uplay Store as hello. Coming up here just shortly, but first, another schedule reminder of the order event. Our Trackmania showcase continues until about 11:30 Pacific time. Then it's Ubisoft Forward. Nálam is meghalt. Tölti, mint a hülye. Getting updates for the crew too. Hearing from Trials Rising about a special... Nálam is tölti. Chiller 1992, köszi a követés, szia-szia, és V2 sok számmal. Szevasz neked is, sziasztok srácok, üdv mindenkinek. Inicsom újra? Micsoda maga a store, vagy... Na várjál. Újra indítom itt a dolgokat. Talk about all the ways that Trackmania can be more competitive. Omar, how's it going, man?
Pretty good, and you? How are you doing?
I'm doing good. Nem hiszem, hogy fog segíteni egy újraindítás, de hát megnézzük, hát ha. Ja, már mosszolok, hogy már most a YouTube meg a Twitch között másfél perces, vagy egy perces delay van. Nekem azt mutatta. Tiamat 1110, köszi a követést. Hát töltés van. De ennyi van.
I'll just take the easy pick and go with Shotty since he won that round.
Ah, okay.
There he is. He's right top of the pops right there.
Yeah.
And keen eye viewer will
know. Valami történt. Just saw
being created, and actually the fifth place player I think in that round is the one who made it. So Tona,
yeah,
you can step it up. I believe in you.
Probably can win at least one round.
I believe it. So as we compete, I wanted to.
Szia Vikóta, szia. Nem sokat segít.
You know, how people kind of like take on new competitive challenges in Trackmania, because you know right from the get-go you're playing, there's the inherent competition of racing. You're trying to get a better medal, a faster time.
Hát ez jött össze. You're racing against your friends. Akkor én ezt veszem egy nemnek, jó? Nálam nem működik. Az AC vallal a 109 eurók, ó, köztetek az infót, annyi, mint annó szólt. Szia Ágica, szia. Késjók hölgyem, szia. Éppen event van, várjuk, amit látod fent van a számlában, és 39 perc múlva, hogy ez a csodálat valamit itt csináljon. Átteszem közben a OBS-t jobbra, hogy lássam, hogy mit művelek. Ez engem annyira zavar, amikor nem egy játékot látom, hanem a saját kijelzőmet így streamelem, az tök furcsa.
I like the streamer touch, because then you can kind of see what they've laid down the time and then go take
your track. Mindegy, fogadjátok el. Lehet, hogy szerencsés volt, és neked működött, nekem most így nem. Nálam most így konkrétan halál van. De nézzétek el. A Watch Dogs 2 9 után lesz ingyenesen elérhető az Uplay-en, vagy máshol kell keresnem majd. Na Krisz, ez egy jó kérdés, mivel a szerverek sem működnek jelen pillanatban. Az, hogy a Watch Dogs 2... Én úgy érzem, hogy nem is fognak működni a szerverek. Van egy ilyen érzésem. És ebből kifolyólag, hogyha a Uplay-é tényleg jó fel akar lenni, akkor mondjuk holnapig kitolják azt, hogy a Watch Dogs 2 beszerezhető ingyen. Én ezt tenném a helyükbe, mert nem fogja bírni a szerverük, meg fog halni az egész. Szia Barel, szia, szép estét! Az Odyssey Ultimate meg 120 euró helyett csak 38 euró. Na, hát csapjatok le rá, srácok, nekem szerencsére az Odyssey az összes AC-ból a... Hát vagyok annyira függő, hogy a Basso Edition van meg. Most viszont elgondolkodok rajta, hogy melyik legyen meg, mert... Anno azért vettem mindigből a Gold Edition-t, mert 3 hónappal hamarabb tudtam vele játszani, és az összes Season Pass járt hozzá. De nem volt szobor, meg nem voltam Magyarországon. Most gondolkodok rajta, hogy melyik legyen. Majd meglátom. Most már azért be lehet rendelni itt Magyarországon, úgyhogy legyen szobor is mellé. Igen, a Uplay coin-nal olcsóbb. Hát tudom, mennyi az a 3-4%-ot kapsz rá? Jó, több mint a semmi az is, természetesen. Remélem, hogy 2 év múlva, majd hogyha kijön az AC-nak majd a következő része, két év múlva, addigra már is kapok bele egy olyan verziót, amit csak így hozzávágnak, hogy tesszék, Chosy, Bonski, Dizdoze verzió és szobor, meg minden jár hozzá, örülnék neki. Lorenceg 45 és Dogo, köszi szépen a követés, sziasztok srácok, üdv mindenkinek, hello, hello. Szevasztok. And we just put them on a special format that we design. Well, everything is possible. Hát Krisz, azért mondom, hogy én most megnéztem, nálam most ez van, várjál. Nálam most ez van jelenleg. Tehát így. A store nem elérhető. De látod, másnál működik. Tehát ez így kérdőjel. Őszintén ezek azt sem tudom, hol játszódhatna a... Hol játszódhatna még a kövi AC? Magyarországon. Instant Magyarországon, srácok, mert ezt beszéltük is, hogy... milyen jó kis... 56-os forradalmas eseményeket lehetne csinálni AC-n belül. Instant Petőfi Assassin, jaja. Nálam sem tölt be semmi. Az Ultimate Edition megírja az új AC-ből? Nem is tudom, hogy mi lesz az Ultimate-be. Gondolom, az összes season. Nem tudom, srácok. Most nagyon sokan jönnek. Mondom, a Ubisoft az egy olyan event, srácok, amit minden évben vár az ember, és most meg kifejezetten várja, mert a tavalyi év azért nem hozott olyan hűde nagy újítást, mert belegondoltak, a Ghost Recon-tól kaptunk egy játékot, ami hatalmas csalódás volt, és meg is ígérte aztán a Ubi, hogy nem is fog kb. Fél éven keresztül semmi játékot kiadni, és tartották is magukat ehhez, mert semmi nem jelent meg, semmi nem volt. Hát kicsit lemegyek maradva a csettel, bocsánat. Micsoda, Magyarországon 2 perc lenne az alma beszerzése parlamentből. Jó, hát toxik, de... Szerintem lenne potenciál egy ilyenbe. Franciaország már volt, simán. Lehozták, az AC2-be is, abba is nyomadtuk Velencével, tehát simán lehetne. Én adnám. Mondanám Romániát, sőt, egy drakulás Assassin's Creed. Ott nem kéne sólyom, nem kéne varjó, te magad repülnél és néznél körbe. Szerintem az lenne a legjobb. A tavalyi nem, azért mondom Tesla, a tavalyi nem volt nagy durranás. Most azon gondolkodok, hogy a melyik event volt az a Ubisoftnál, amikor a Just Dance volt beboostolva, és a karakterek beöltöztek be és jöttek be. Arra emlékeztek? Volt egy ilyen event? Na, nekem az nagyon tetszett. Nem tudom, hogy a 2019, talán a 19-es Just Dance volt az, azt nagyon jól megcsinálták. Talán a 2020 az meg így el volt ilyen pöttyelve. Lehet az volt. Na, az nekem nagyon tetszett. Már azért mondom, hogy a tavalyi az így el lett cseszve. Szerintem azért várja mindenki ekkora búzban most a Jobbit, aztán nehogy csalódjunk. Wow, the time separating the top finishes. 19, ha. E3, azt nem tudom. De az E3-nak az egyik napján, mert ott több rendezvény volt egymás után, de most mivel nem volt E3, mert elmaradt, szóval ez most nem ilyen külön Ubisoft bemutatás, mert itt ez most az, de nem így szokott lenni, hanem az E3-on szokták bemutatni a cuccokat. De most ilyen nem lesz. Ahogy lehet, hogy bele kéne írjam a chatbe az, hogy hun mi. Már most, ha én benyomok egy eventet és jönnek itt az emberek ezzel rá, franciából, meg olaszból, meg mindenhol, akkor az lehet, hogy zavaró lesz. E3 felbontva, igen.
Can go from first to last basically by doing one mistake and one short mistake, so that's pretty exciting.
És ott van fent a számláló, tehát így, és ott fölöttem van a számláló srácok, ott lehet látni. Úgy, úgy álltam hozzá, hogy nem várok nagy dolgokat, és maximum kellemesen csalódok a végén. Yep. De én ezért nem néztem semmit, mondom, nem néztem gameplayeket, nem néztem trailereket, játékokra, amik megjelennek, tehát semmit nem néztem. Majd lesz ami. Aztán valahogy csattanni fog. De a Far Cry-t az biztos, hogy kíváncsi leszek rá, mert végig fogom játszani újra a legelejétől. Annó YouTube-on a Far Cry 3, meg az 5, meg annak a DLC, az a zombis mód, azok voltak meg végigjátszva, visszanézve, de a szar minőségben volt. Lancelot, köszi a követést. Töröltem. Azokat mind töröltem. Már csak abból kifolyólag is, hogy végigjátszuk a legelejéről. Várkely 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. New Dawn, ugye? Az volt. Meg a DLC-ket is. Igen, lesz Far Cry franchise végigjátszás, csak először be kell fejeznem a Batmant, aztán pedig a Tomb Raider-t, és utána jött a Far Cry. Meg, mint mondtam nektek, összeírtam a menetrendet, így toldat fel is olvastam így gyorsban, hogy mik lesznek. Mindegy, most ne beszéljünk arról, most Ubi van, jó? Most Ubisoft van, most arról beszéljünk, hogy mik lesznek majd itt.
Maybe at the end of the week you'll be able to beat people that you wouldn't even think.
Igen, O'Brien, tehát nincs semmi elvárásom. Tehát semmi elvárásom nincs ezzel kapcsolatosan, hogy mi lesz. Tavaly utána nézegettem a programlistát, hogy mik lesznek, de már ott is csúszás volt. Mert őszintén nem is tudom, hogy ez mennyire lesz úgy, hogy most otthon jelentik be a cuccokat, vagy van egy kisebb gála, ahova beültek, ezt se tudom például, hogy ez hogy lesz kivitelezve. Flower, köszi a követést! A Far Cry 2-ben lehettél magyar? Na, ezt nem tudom. Szétszpemelik Watch Dogs 2-vel? Hát, látod. Már behúzom a pontot, ott van. Kattints, bónusz behúzom. Kell a bónusz.
Looks like Omar backed the right racer. Shorty coming in with a victory. And Omar, thank you so much for talking about competitive track mania.
Valaki kérdezte, mit tartalmaznak a különböző csomagok az AC-val, a DC-ből. A hírek szobában benne van.
Thanks to all the closed alpha players we had, because they help us truly to make this game better, and we're pretty happy with what the Trackmania we have right now. So yeah, just play Trackmania, it's free, and have fun on it. I'm pretty sure you'll have.
Ránézek.
That's it.
All right, Omar. Thank you so much.
A Collector's Edition, ami nem tudom mennyibe kerül.
Get in there and get racing. Now our time with Trackmania is coming to a close, and it's on to the.
De vari. A Collectorsban van benne a szobor, meg minden egyes ingóság, ami jól nézhet ki.
Thank you, Chris, and hello everyone, and welcome to the Ubisoft Forward pre-show. The main event will be.
Átdobjam amúgy a képet, srácok.
Feature news from our unreleased games, including Watch Dogs Legion, Assassin's Creed Valhalla, Hyperscape, and more.
Így jobb lesz, nem? 30 minit.
Ghost Recon Breakpoint, Trials Rising, and The Crew 2. As well as some exclusive behind the scenes so you can get to know us a little better. So let's kick off this pre-show with an update from Just Dance 2020.
Yeah!
Don't complain.
nagyon, nagyon Ready Player One-ra mennek rá most minden témában. A Pedomaci befigyel.
If you're a Just Dance fan and want to win some cool swag, head over to the Just Dance website for all the details. For our next segment, we have something a little different than what we usually do. A few years ago, Ubisoft created the Ubisoft Entrepreneurs Lab and the Open Innovation Accelerator. This allowed us to create partnerships and synergies with studios from across the industry.
Kamerával vagy move controllerrel.
We wanted to showcase several indie projects and teams that Ubisoft has been collaborating with over the past few years.
Our first indie showcase is developer Machine & Mensch, who is working on The Curious Expedition 2. Let's hear more from the team behind the game.
Yeah, Lenárk.
Hi, my name is Masha and I'm a game designer at Machine & Mensch.
Yeah, that is okay.
It's a small and diverse indie game studio.
Kis lelkes a hölgy.
Wonderful employees based here in Berlin. Our connection with Ubisoft came through a program dedicated to create ever-growing relationships with independent developers. To talk about and share experiences
and Lucifer,
much appreciated.
We're working on The Curious Expedition 2, which is the sequel to our Expedition Simulation game. This time, the game is set in Paris in 1899 during the World Expo when the Eiffel Tower was built. But more importantly, you will be traveling to these mysterious islands. You will be interacting with unknown tribes, fight dangerous
beasts, and find many secrets.
Thanks to our procedure technology, every time you play, it's a new world, new characters, and a new storyline that you shape with each of your interactions until it becomes
your own unique adventure. Szavazok, srácok, köszi a követéseket. Indie Highlight, amúgy az van kiírva. Oh, elérhető.
And we will have more indie guests coming up later in the pre-show, so stick around. Now, a while ago, Ubisoft released its very first live-action TV show on Apple TV+.
Szevasz, Black, köszönjük, és
sziasztok, srácok! Called Mythic Quest Raven's Banquet. And to keep the show authentic, Ubisoft's Red Storm Studio went above and beyond by creating a playable sandbox for the game that is actually featured in the show. So now, let's head behind the scenes for an exclusive look.
This is the home of Clay.
Okay. It's very Clancy-esque.
Yes.
I get it. All right, now I'm starting to understand.
Köszi a követéseket,
srácok. I keep all my awards at the front of my office. It's entirely empty. So Mythic Quest is Ubisoft's first...
Ott a háttérben láttam, mi van a háttérben? Én pont akartam, bakker. Láttátok, mi volt a háttér? Figyeld, ott a Space Monkey.
All the people within the game development team and their relationships.
Ott a Space Monkey gyerekek.
Creating one of the world's most successful games.
Alright. Csak pont akartam.
Incredible.
Thank you.
But are we sure that we're finished?
When we heard about what was going on, we weren't really sure if we were a great fit because we've always made shooters realistic. And we listened to the pitch and we were super
excited. Ez jelent valamit. Easter egg volt a háttérben, én már láttam.
We thought, alright, what does Ubisoft have that we could channel to fit this?
You're fucking me. Beyond Good and Evil, második része.
But I'm not enjoying it. It's for the game.
When we started on the project, I think we imagined we would just make video clips that would run on screens in the background or something, so it would feel like a real game studio. But once we saw the script, once we started collaborating with the team, we realized, oh, they want a game, like an actual game.
Mindenki bekövetesen. Én most már levettem az alertet, jó? Kiraktam, hogy Hun only.
And from there, it was not long before we said, you know, what if we make this actually playable? What if we make it so you can connect a controller and control the characters? And so that's what we ended up doing.
The thing that I love most is the shuffle.
Ki az a kis stressz?
This thing is straight fire. Crunch, man.
We had requests to do things like make a contagious viral disease in which people bleed out of their eyeballs first, then they bleed out of their anus, then they vomit and bleed out of their anus at the same time.
We set it up in such a way that you could trigger it in stages because we didn't know what the timing was going to be. The idea here is we can hit it and control the timing of when things happen.
So
the next time you hit it, he starts puking out blood. And at this point, we would probably have the camera start panning back.
Kicsit túlzásnak érzem.
And you see the blood ocean itself has started coming
Jézus
in. So now they're all bleeding out of the back end as well.
And then nagyon jó, csoportos vérhányás.
Bloody gore, and then this was Keith's idea. He wanted the skulls coming up and bobbing up and down in the water, so.
David, can we actually make this quick? I've got a lot of work to do stripping blood ocean out of them.
Is a home office van, mindenki is megőrülnek az emberek. Ilyeneket csinál. Global pandemic was
not a great look. Today was the first time we showed
Mythic. Ez a csávó, de ismerős. Ez nem egy színész. I've
seen it with more than six or seven people in a room. And so I wanted to make sure that we gave them an opportunity to hopefully recognize that this is a giant love letter to them. To the industry itself.
Nagyon ismerős volt a csávónak az arca, de hol?
I thought it was going to be a little cringy, but it was fantastic.
I thought there was a lot of truth and in the humor. It's about time that we had a show about our industry.
You could tell when the audience was laughing, when they really hit something that felt like the game industry.
Még 21 perc. I think it's brilliant. Nincs Apple TV-m, jó? Ne haragudj. Netflixen van.
Of Mythic Quest Raven's Banquet is available right now on Apple TV Plus, and a full version of this making of will be coming out over the next few days. All right, now it is time to fasten your seatbelts and start your engines as we head to Lyon, France, to visit our team at Ubisoft Ivory Tower to get an update on the Crew 2.
Hát ennek talán megnéztem a bétáját, de ez amikor hajóval, motorral különböző járműket tudsz menni.
It's been 2 years already since launch.
Már kint jöttél, azt mondom, legalább angolok hagykövessenek. Hát itt volt, mindenki bekövetett. Francia, orosz, japán, mindent kaptam. Azért is vettem le a hangot. Nem mai a Crew 2. 2-3 éves, nem tudom. 2 éves, nem? 18-as a Crew? Vagy 4? Nem tudom. Nem tudom, mikor jelent meg. Emlékeztek arra a játék, hogy Midnight Club? Nekem arra emlékeztetett ez a játék, a Midnight Clubra. Abba volt úgy autó, motor, már abban nem volt hajó. 18, ah.
We can't wait for you to get your hands on what's coming.
Igen, mert kaptam hozzá kódot még annól, hogy kipróbálhattam, így hamarabb, azt tudom, de annyira nem. De az volt a Midnight Club. Jól mondtam akkor, Shadow.
Exchange, Discord, Reddit, and all of our players. We've got a little something for you in-game to show our appreciation. It's the 67 Volkswagen Beetle. So let's see what kind of Hollywood twist you can put on it.
Na jó, azért ez nagyon, nagyon menő.
More news dropping over summer, so keep your eyes peeled. Starting with this.
Igen, jó kis DeLorean. Nagyon rámentek erre a 80-as évekre, mi történt? Azért, mert jön a Ready Player 2 és mindenki ezt csinálja, 80-as évek? Szia Pedzsi, szia! Nagyon retro, de most minden rámet a retróra.
Make sure to boot up the game right now to unlock the amazing 69 Volkswagen Beetle that was just shown in the video. And stay tuned in the near future for more info about year 3 of the Crew 2. Our next video is from our second indie guest, Bossa Studios, who will be injecting a delirious dose of fun with Surgeon Simulator 2. Enjoy!
Nem, Pecs, jön film is.
Hi, I'm Nate from Bossa Studios, and I'm a senior game designer on the upcoming Surgeon Simulator 2. So at Bossa, we're always
Jézusom!
And Ubisoft has been a fantastic
Na ez nekem való, gyerekek! They deliver lectures ez on nekem való! Content development
and player science. And we shared with them the ideation processes
that Ugyan we used to develop initial ideas games. Ez nekem
Which
való!
Brings me on to Surgeon Simulator 2. We've really doubled down on the physics-based pandemonium.
Dr. Cho, lehozza!
And we've pretty much expanded on every other aspect of the game as well. So this time around, you're no longer just a floating hand confined to the operating table.
There's VR,
you're actually a full first-person surgeon, with an entire medical facility to explore.
Szerintem ez VR, nem?
And in addition to the levels that you'll find in story mode, you'll now be able to create your own unique levels and experiences using Bossa Labs creation mode.
De király!
It's really easy to use, intuitive set of tools that allows players to create either on their own or in online multiplayer with up to 3 friends. Everything players create can then be uploaded and shared with the community.
Hoztenni a műtőt.
And here surgery really is just the tip of the iceberg.
Miért így van a kezük?
During our closeout period, we've seen players create all sorts of amazing stuff.
Hát ez egy kóba, ezt nyomni elég beteg lehet.
Pirate ships to horror-themed escape rooms.
Mi?
And this is before the game is even released.
Úristen.
So we absolutely cannot wait to see what players create when we launch the game this coming August.
And in Bobby
fact,
sick.
If you pre-order Surgeon Simulator 2, you can receive exclusive closed beta access.
Ez beteg,
so
ez elég beteg.
For those of you who just joined us, you're watching the pre-show, and Ubisoft Forward will start once the countdown on your screen reaches zero. And make sure you log into Uplay to unlock rewards as you watch the main event. But now, our next segment is about an Easter egg in The Division 2, so let's go behind the scenes with the devs from Ubisoft Massive Studio in Malmö, Sweden to find out more.
Running through collapsed buildings, nem tudom, nem tudtam azonosulni. Az első 5 óra nagyon jó volt a Division 2-ben. Lehet, hogy nem volt rá emberem, akikkel játszhattam volna, lehet azért, akkoriban azért nem jut át annyira. Kacsa Easter-ek?
In programming especially where you talk to a rubber duck and it's a way to solve your problems. If you talk to a rubber duck and you just say things out loud, it helps. One of our artists decided to take this to another level and he used the rubber duck scaled up to like a ginormous scale. Put it in the level just to remind him to do something.
Szép estét.
And the rest of us kind of really loved this giant rubber duck sitting there for so long. We decided to put a little memorial to it across the world. What started off as little memorials and then we started adding stories to them. So there's one where these two ducks are sitting
and
having a date together. And there's another one somewhere where
sitting in the
umbrella hiding
from the rain. The idea of the ducks
is similar to the rest of our storytelling where we're trying to add some hope into the world.
So the
try and save what you can and rebuild. But you need to know there's something there to save. So having bits of happiness lets you know like, it's still worth kettő. Saving.
Mármint, hogy most bejelentés. Az hatalmas pofon lenne. Pozitívan.
Showing up multiple times across YouTube and Reddit.
So, Karen, how was your day?
Well, Luke, it's been productive.
So the origin story of productive. One of our level designers made an amazing pun one day and we decided to make a graffiti out of it and put it in the game.
These best deal.
Like a duck shrine and players started finding it and wondering where it came from.
We've been finding these rubber duckies all over the map. It says here on the wall in graffiti productive. And there's a large rubber ducky, bigger than all the other ones we've found. And he's got bottles of booze all around. Not only that, but he has a couple soldier duckies guarding a parrot in a cage.
Milyennek van Joker-es kacsája, az menőbb. Joker-es kacsája van, megnyerte. Az egyik közösség találkozóra vittem ilyen különböző cuccokat, amiket kisorsoltam, és jól tudom, milyen nyerte meg. Szia Lori, szia!
So that means players
are lila, zöld, fehér, nagyon durván néz ki a Joker-es kacsa.
And finding all these little Easter eggs we've hidden around. And also not the Easter eggs, just the main part of the game and all the storytelling we put into it. I haven't found all of them. I don't know exactly how many there are, but they haven't found all of the ducks yet.
Encouraged by the community's response to the ducks, developers recently hid another secret in the game and made it the focal point of an all-new community challenge.
We actually put Tommy the Teddy Bear into the game. Well, Tommy the Teddy Bear is a trauma teddy mentioned in a lot of lore, but the bear itself actually was not in the game. With episode 3, we put a bunch of them into the world, actually opened up Easter egg hunt for him specifically.
It's a nice little exciting moment when you kind of open Reddit and you see someone's found the thing that you kind of just snuck in under the radar and no one really knows about it. And it some of the players are really clever. There's some hard Easter eggs that some of the level designers and gameplay designers have put in, and people have managed to solve it with no help whatsoever.
So now that you know, be on the lookout for both the ducks and teddy bears next time you boot up The Division 2. We now have our final indie guest, Thunder Lotus Games, who were the 2017 winner of the indie series that took place in Montreal. So let's find out more about the beautiful coziness of Spiritfarer in this next video.
Hey everybody, I'm Rodrigue, marketeer at Thunder Lotus. We're an indie studio based out of Montreal, Canada, and makers of the games Jotun, Sundered, and our new game Spiritfarer, which is due out later this year. For the past 6 years, we've tried to make AAA quality games with a hand-drawn indie heart. Hitting a quality standard consistently in game dev is a huge challenge. There's so much trial and error on the path, and during the Sundered production, we were
lucky enough to have a Ubisoft fiókunk csatlakoztatva a Twitch-re. Most én azt nézem, nem tudom, hogy van-e drop, vagy mire kell menni, legyen. De a Ubisoft fiók csatlakoztatva most a
Twitch-emhez. So we're grateful to Ubisoft for their support and helping us make what would become our biggest success to date. We've taken that experience with us onto what is our most ambitious production yet, and that's Spiritfarer, which we're calling a cozy management game.
That I did this mini Spiritfarer,
you play Stella, the newly appointed fairy master to the deceased. And as Stella, you're going to build
a
world in search of spirit passengers seeking passage to the afterlife.
És hol kell aktiválni?
Quality time with them, you're gonna create lasting memories.
Küldd egyszer a linket, aztán aktiválom, ahogy van.
Learn how to say goodbye to your cherished friends. It's a game that's near and dear to our hearts and something really special. We can't wait to share it with the world later this year. So look for it soon on PC, on Xbox One, PS4, Nintendo Switch, and Xbox Game Pass. Thanks a lot. Cheers.
It is time for an update on our favorite motorcycle platformer with the insanity, pain, and triumph we all know and we all love. Trials Rising came out last year, but I think the team from our Red Link studio in Helsinki has a little surprise coming to the game for the fans of the franchise. So let's take a look.
Ooh, de komoly. These bad things, Shazza.
Hi, we're here today to introduce you to an exciting new endurance challenge coming to Trials Rising. But to make sure that we respect social distancing guidelines, Auntie and I decided
to... Do I fire the goose now?
What? Fire the goose?
Fire! Okay!
Jesus.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Giga Track.
Ezt próbáltam egyszer. Ezt tetszett viszont.
Far from a remake of the classic track from Trials Evolution, this is an all-new journey across the
world. Ezt akarjátok majd, srácok? Annó volt ez a game. Amúgy rohadt néz, egy idő után rohadt néz a játék.
By far the longest track we've ever put in a Trials game. The Giga Track will take you across many different environments.
Az első 3-4 pálya az olyan fán volt, utána meg már egyre rage-be ment át a game, mert rohadt nehéz volt.
Yeah, I was just... Maybe you want to tell them.
The Giga Track is like life. It starts and it ends and it's long. Depends how you enjoy it. And also one secret thing. 4 tells to answer to 1.
Prepare for the ultimate test of Trials Endurance. Giga Track releases this Thursday, July 16th, for the low, low price of...
If you tell them it's free!
You heard that right, riders. Giga Track will be available for free to all Trials Rising players when it releases this Thursday.
You
heard that right, the Giga Track is coming to the game and it will be the longest, most insane track in Trials history and it will be free for all Trials Rising players. Now for our last game update, the Ghost Recon Breakpoint team is ready to share some details on their upcoming update. AI teammates are coming to the game.
Let's have a look at the trailer. Nagyon szomorú voltam emiatt.
The time has come. AI teammates are back in Ghost Recon Breakpoint.
Nagyon szétszették ezt a gémet.
And for all solo players,
nagyon durván szétszették ezt a gémet.
They're gonna be a game changer.
Szia, Edna, szia.
Available at any point after you have reached Erewhon for the first time, Fury, Fixit, and Vasily can be activated or dismissed at will. And from the beginning, you will be able to fully customize them. This customization includes all of the physical attributes, as well as gear, equipment, or even full costumes. Your teammates can be
tweaked just as much as your main character. Kapok itt közbe.
Just like Nomad,
sziasztok.
Your teammates will adapt and react to the world of
your own environments.
And they will always follow your own behavior. If you decide to go stealth, they will equip silencers
and crash or
drone when possible. But if you decide to go loud and open fire, they will stick by your side. When deployed, you can issue different orders to your teammates through the order wheel. There are four different orders you can give to your teammates. You can tell them to regroup on your location, to hold their current position, to go to a specific location, and to open fire on nearby enemies.
These orders can be given at any time, even through your binoculars
and drone. Once they approach potential
threats,
the teammates will notify you and mark them automatically.
Got a hostile.
With a good look at your enemies, you will be able to set up a sync shot where each of your teammates picks a target.
Szia, köszi a követést. Hello, hello. Sziasztok, srácok.
Three sync shot drones for a simultaneous 7-target takedown. The teammates have weapons equipped at all times.
Nem most a dropot akartam bekapcsolni nálatok, hogy lehessen drop a Twitch-nél, mert megtaláltam az Ubisofton belül, de nem enged belépni.
Apart from mark upgrades and passive bonuses, the full gunsmith is
nem ez a Twitch dropos összekapcsolás, csak hát nem adja.
Depending on the type of weapon they have, the teammates will adapt their engagement distance and rate of fire. From close distance shotgun wielding, all the way to long distance sniper shots. Of course, if you get taken down, your teammates' priority will be to try and rescue you. To achieve that, they will first focus their fire on the surrounding enemies before getting to you. And they will expect the same from you, especially as you will be able to carry them to safety if the situation requires it. Finally, the teammates will also be your best allies in any vehicle, especially on the road and during high-stake pursuits. The teammates will be available for
all solo and three-point players on July 15th,
and we cannot wait to see your reactions. We'll see you on
Július 15. Három nap. Három nap. Szia András, szia. Ghost Recon Breakpoint.
I'm Grace from the Ghost Recon team.
Csajok, miért van ez az orrotokba? Miért kell ez az orrotokba? Ez mi? A bikáknak szokott jelenni az orrotokba, de miért kell az orrotokba értelni?
New PvP content.
Mindenki, jó, mindenki a saját dolga, de nekem én ezt
így nem. Try it all during our next free weekend from July 16th to July 20th. But that's not all, we've got one last thing to show you. Enjoy, and we'll see you on Aroa, Ghosts.
To anyone listening, this is Haruhi Ito, speaking for the Outcasts. We stand against
Suki, what a
legal occupation of Aroa. We call on all of Aroa to join us. Separated, Sentinel wins. But united, we cannot be defeated.
And now our very final video for this pre-show is another episode of our wow moments compiling the craziest and coolest clips from you, our players.
Anyone else want to try to do better than that?
Bocs, muszáj volt gyerekek újra tölteni, hát ez nem bírom én ezt a stresszt. Elfogyott a tejám. Nos, hát hoztam teját, srácok. Mindenki nyugodja meg, hoztam teját, jó? Két perc, még két perc. Jó, is elhat. Én is így nyomom.
I was gonna interrogate him.
you can interrogate this guy though.
Oh, okay.
Op 4, last stop standing.
Ott volt előtt a csávó. Mi a fasz? Az igen. Csóri, csóri.
So there's a line that people want me to yell. But I can't usually do it because I'll freak out my
neighbors.
But as you can see, I'm at the crash in Ocean Beach and there's no one too close, so reloading! Fuck, someone told me. I gotta go.
Lábbal. Hagyjad már magad. Lábbal csinált a csaj. Hát oké. Okay.
If you also have amazing gameplay segments you captured from our games, spread the joy and submit them on the link displayed on your screen right now. All right, guys, it is time for us to wrap up this pre-show.
Don't forget to stay tuned for our post-show featuring a deep dive into the world of Assassin's Creed Valhalla.
Thanks a lot for watching this pre-show and enjoy Ubisoft Forward.
Na nézzük, mit hoztatok össze, srácok? 10 másodperc még, úristen! Mi történnek? Itt kezdődik, gyerekek! Szétcsúszunk, szétcsúszunk! És go!
Hi everyone, I'm Neelam Kumar and I'm very excited to be co-hosting the first Ubisoft Forward with the talented Yusuf Magid. Today's show is all about getting up close and in depth with all the exciting games we have in production here at Ubisoft.
I'm Yusuf, but there's no time to waste.
Yo,
so let's
head straight
for the streets of futuristic London and see what the hackers of DedSec are getting into.
Watch Dogs 3.
The illegal painting spreading subversive and hostile messaging over the last few weeks across London.
Ez még nem gameplay, ahogy írják. Ez még nem gameplay.
The work of an individual. The criminal suspected to have links with the terrorist group.
Again.
Authorities recommend not to approach the individual.
First, they came for the foreigners, and I did not speak out because I was not a foreigner. Then they came for the protesters, and I did not speak out.
Azért van egy cyberpunk feeling. Jó, már mindenki is tudom, tudom.
Then they came for the journalists, and I did not speak out because I was not a journalist. And then they came for street artists, but I did not speak out because I am not a street artist.
Eléggé megváltozott London, mióta nem jártam arra. Az igen. Ezek a live action trailerek tök jók amúgy. Ez a Piccadilly Circus.
And I realized that eventually they'd come for me, and there would be no one left to speak for me.
Érdekes. Nem. A CGI persze. De hírtak az elején, hogy ez nem gameplay. Hol a London Eye? Ezek a fókuszugrálgatások menő, de... Azért na. Köszi a követéseket, srácok. Kösz mindenkinek. Ajaj.
Welcome to the Resistance. There's a welcome gift for our new members. But the disappearance
of the criminal... You could have told me it was a bloody costume party.
Try it on.
The new key suspect has been identified as David Ford, a 43-year-old London taxi driver. He has no criminal record...
Igen, pont ez lesz a szépségével a játéknak, hogy nagyon-nagyon sok karakter tudsz irányítani, nagyon sok stílusú karakter tudsz irányítani. 80-as évek style. Nagyon ráfeküdtek a retróra így az elmúlt covidos korszakban, de jó, tesz ez a játék. Én még úgy érzem, nem lesz ebből probléma. Ez a 2020-21-es év erről fog szólni, a retróról, a gyerekek.
So yeah, what we just saw was an amazing short film by the director Alberto Mielgo. That
nem was inspired by Watch Dogs Legion and looks
at the game and the universe and the characters through his incredible artistic vision and visual style.
Szia, Zsuhit! Szia, szia!
City needs a resistance.
Like the film, Watch Dogs Legion tells the story of ordinary heroes setting aside their differences in order to come together as a collective and to fight for a positive change. You can literally recruit and play anyone who you see in the open world. You profile people that are interested in you.
Igen, és most nem csak erre gondolok, nem csak a Ubisoftra, hogy nagyon sok minden kirámed most a retróra.
Sounds like a dead sec problem. Leave it to us.
And that's how you recruit them into your team. And then they become the heroes of the game and the stars of your story.
And what are you doing in my flat? You with Albion?
Please, think more underground.
You with Albion?
I'm tickled, but think more underground.
What, DedSec? Yeah, right, and I'm Che Guevara. You're done.
And they make the story not only, you know, unique to them, but unique to you as the player and personal to you because they're, you know, heroes that you've chosen and invested
in.
What would I say to fans? I guess I'd say, you know, take care of yourselves, stay safe. Welcome to the Resistance.
Nice.
Ah, London town.
Na, ott is van.
A modern metropolis.
Már nem, ez már modern, ez jó.
Built on history and prosperity. Only took 12,000 years to build it up, and one night to tear it all down.
Oh my God.
Listen up. Get all your units to move in and lock down the city.
Altra felgár volt, ha? Mutasd merre lettek. Hárma zóna.
The government turns to a private military company called Albion to keep everyone safe. What could possibly go wrong? Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Nigel Cass, CEO of Albion. He's kindly stepped up to establish order.
Understand this.
Jaj, jó,
I will not allow anyone, not even myself, to jeopardize this.
He will stop at nothing to permanently control the city.
London will be the first city in the world.
Gondolom, azt már kitaláltátok, hogy végigjátszom az 1-2-t.
Nigel's not the only opportunist who's taken a liking
to this fair city. Egy résszel se játszottam, srácok, egy résszel se játszottam.
Meet Mary Kelly, head of the most powerful crime syndicate in London.
Be sure and spread the word.
She and her goons are using the dark web to sell everything, from party pills to people.
This
microchip is scary, aren't
it? Minden elkereskedik, amivel kell. Jól csinálja.
You made me a slave.
You do not want to ruffle her feathers. With the city out
ja,
of
ja, még. Mondom, az 1-2-t
végignyom először. Build a resistance and take back London.
A dog.
All right, everyone. Faces on, guns out.
Any of the brave Londoners you see walking the streets can be recruited into your team. Like him. Her. Or even her.
Sokkola.
Everyone can become your next secret
weapon. Jók ezek a stílusok.
In our first mission, we need to get some dirt on Nigel Cass, and that means breaking into Albion headquarters inside the Tower of London. All the hardy souls you see here are people we have recruited from the streets of London.
They all have unique abilities,
and you're free to tackle this mission with whoever you like.
Cut my eyes. Bagley! Zip up, get to work, and let's never talk about this again.
Várják, most megadott karakterek lesznek, mert én azt hittem, hogy csak hogy bárkibe bele tudsz bújni.
But as a construction worker, he has a particular set of tools that make him handy. He can even call his own cargo drone. Perfect for gate crashing.
Elég megborult amúgy a játék.
And who needs a regular old gun when you have a bloody nail gun?
Come here, you soidoid shithorn. Jesus Christ, what is that thing?
Perhaps we could approach this mission differently. If you'd rather keep your distance, we've got your cover.
Yeah, but yeah, this is.
Amy is a drone expert.
What have we here?
A real tech connoisseur.
Hate spiders, but love this one.
What an adorable creepy crawler.
Here we are. Let's class the place up.
A drone expert does have the unique ability to summon their own drone. This little darling is fast and stealthy.
She aims, she fires, she hits.
I'm reading incoming drones.
She can also hack enemy drones, turning the tide in her favor. And if you are not into direct confrontation, there are more ways than one to get the job done. Recruiting an Albion officer like Brielle here might be challenging, but it'll get you inside restricted Albion areas.
Don't mind me, just doing recon for a bunch of insurgents.
However, do anything suspicious and she'll probably wind up with a bullet in the back of her head.
You've been approved for entry.
We're missing the human element here. I can get the defense minister on the line right now.
Well, if you feel you must.
Azért hitmenek más atmoszférája van, mint ennek.
Criminals running our streets, illegals threatening our families, the police commissioner himself, assassinated by terrorists.
Well, that seems to be enough evidence. Next up, we're crashing Mary Kelly's organ farming operation and putting a stop to it.
That's good. The buyers expect high quality stuff.
And we need a hard nut for this.
Impairing our frontal lobe again, are we?
Bags. Don't disturb me in my natural habitat.
Say hello to Mickey. The man lives for his team.
That put another air on my chest.
Én ismerek ilyen kadliverő embereket, aki csak kosmába volt és csak ezeket csinálta. Na, megvan az én karakterem szerintem.
He does have a slight...
Na! Töltés van. Csak nálam állt meg. F5-ölt, nyugi, nyugi, nyugi.
A professional.
Megoldottam. Ó, ez Keanu Reeves. Na ez inkább úgy néz ki, mint a...
It's almost crass to call him a hitman.
Ez tényleg úgy néz ki, bakker. Vagy lehet, hogy ez az én karakterem. Na jó, nem. Ez az én karakterem. Bocsánat. Ez az én karakterem. Ez John Wick, ez instant John Wick, gyerekek.
Some might even call him an artist.
Azt a most... Jó. Megvan, ez az enyém. Ez rohadtul az.
Done and dusted.
Jó, ez tényleg jó. Not bad if I do say so, innit? Ez tényleg az én karakterem.
Not everyone in London is a legendary assassin or a super spy, but everyone can be a hero. So get out there, find the best recruits,
Lord.
And build your resistance. It's time to take back London.
Igen. Igen. Azért mondom, hogy azért nem lehet London összes emberébe irányítani, hogy mondták. Október 29.
Plunging the player into a living,
születésnapom lesz, gyerekek.
Teaming with unique locales and characters has always been a central pillar of the Watch Dogs series.
So what goes into building those worlds? Here's Amanda Mutt to tell us more.
My name's Amanda Mutt. I'm a level artist on Watch Dogs Legion at Ubisoft Toronto. Being a level artist, I think, is the coolest job in video games because we do get the freedom to kind of like pick and choose what little details we want to depict, and we get ample opportunities to tell the stories that we want to tell in the spaces that we're assigned to. I have the capacity to hide things and, you know, like small little Easter eggs.
Mennyire maszek már, hogy
AC Unity, there was a boat somewhere in the world.
Hogy ott van a kamera alatt egy kis doboz, hogy az arcfogasságban legyen.
And it happened again in Watch Dogs 2, and there may or may not be something in London that is a boat filled with cats in some capacity. So.
Azért nem kis projektekbe volt része a csajnak.
Some of the people that I was showing our demo to were from London, so no matter where I dropped them in the city, they'd go, oh my god, this feels like Camden, this, you know, this feels like Southwark, this feels like Westminster. When people are talking about some detail that I've put into the world and they're excited about it, like that feels so good as somebody who, you know, builds
these
worlds.
Milyen dobozra van a kamera?
I love it.
And now some news for Brawlhalla fans. In just a few weeks, you'll be able to battle with your favorite legends on iOS and Android devices.
A Brawlhallára. Mindenki erre vár. Csetem mindig kérdezik, hogy mikor lesz, nekem is, persze, mert ingyenes a játék. De hogy nem rossz. Jön telóra. Ez az. Raven, mit keresett benne? Ez az. Augusztus 6-tól lehet telón is játszani vele. Király. Ez az. És kapunk egy pedomacit.
And now, whether you need a Tom Clancy action fix on the go, or want to dive back into one of the most beloved fantasy franchises in gaming, we've got you covered.
Na, az jó. Szerintem az jó volt.
The target is being held on the ground floor.
Go, go, go!
Mi a fene ez? Ez még milyen R6 mód? Ez eléggé vegyítették, mert az a Ghost Recon-ból volt, nem? Lord.
Contact! Mole chain is down. Request air support. Target northeast rooftop.
Roger. Inbound. Danger close.
I need an EMP deployed now.
EMP imminent.
Me off van there. Sam.
Get back in your cell!
LOL.
Hey, take this.
Jó, összemixelték. Á, más a hangja. Elite Squad. Ezt azért megnézem.
Speaking of Tom Clancy, it's been 5 years since
Rainbow Six Siege first launched. Ezt azért meg, attól, hogy Telos Game ezt megnézem, hogy kíváncsi
vagyok rá. In celebration of this milestone,
Ubisoft Montreal miatt,
has put together a special Sprinted video to get all the amazing players and developers that have helped Siege become the game it is today.
Elite League.
In December 2015, a small team released Rainbow Six Siege.
Teljesen másképp nézett még ki.
A game built on a strong vision. Creativity, competitiveness, and team play.
Pour le joueur, le 1er décembre, c'est un début, mais pour nous aussi. Il faut tout de suite s'engager. Tu peux t'y installer aussi, et nous serons là.
De milyen durva, hogy nem voltak le a játékról.
Passionate community, propelling it to a whole new level.
This is such a special moment, and being at 1 year anniversary of Rainbow Six now, game being stronger than ever, more players today than we had in the past, it means the world to us.
But we also had our share of challenges.
Health that touches upon subjects like matchmaking, connectivity, all those aspects are absolutely critical to the experience of the player.
Through it all, we're always driven by you, our community, and together, we grow stronger.
Igazi, az erratól összehoztak valamit a srácok, főleg így, hogy nem mondtak le róla, frissítették az egész játékot, és foglalkoznak vele azóta is. Persze, én nem vagyok nagy erratos.
Les succès, c'est vraiment le résultat de autant de nous que de vous. Ce jeu, il est autant le vôtre qu'il est le nôtre, nous, l'équipe de développement.
Now 60 million players strong, we're just getting started. From the devs that build the game to the community that plays it, thank you.
Ott volt a zúzó, láttátok? Milyen király.
If you haven't tried it yet, dive into our new Operation Steel Wave update available now and take Ace and Malusi out for a spin.
A few days ago, we introduced y'all to a brand new multiplayer shooter. Now, it's time to venture into the hyperscape.
Na nézzük. Ennek lehetett most játszani a bétájával, vagy a zárszerókkal. Én is jelentkeztem rá, aztán hát, ha kapok rá majd engedélyt.
What was that? A hack in a hyperscape. That's not supposed to be there. Let me get you all up to speed, okay? About 30 years ago, everything that we feared about our future.
Ez a hyper-es útjaja.
We made some good decisions. We made some bad decisions. Actually, we made a lot of bad decisions.
Yeah.
So, here we are. 10 billion souls living in the crush of the megacities. But the people at Prisma changed everything. They gave everyone a way out. The Hyperscape. In the Hyperscape, the biggest draw by far is Crown Rush. This is where anyone can become someone.
Ez hitelesebb ez a sztori. Sztori a Battle Royale-ba, hogy ez hitelesebb. Kicsit, ez most már tényleg Ready Player One-os kategória, ahol van egy cél, amiért a játékosok küzdenek a virtuális világban. Ez instant Ready Player One.
If you get good at Crown Rush, it can change your life. But strange things have been happening.
Ez hihetőbb, mint hogy valakit bezárnak egy szigetre, ez hihetőbb, hogy a világ így alakult és génmanipulált lett mindenki. Ez sokkal jobban lehet ezzel azonosulni, szerintem.
A darker secret lies at the heart of Hyperscape. And we have to find it. Some of us are searching for a way up. Some of us for a way out. And for others, a new way all
most ha belegondoltak, akkor a Ubisoft ilyen téren földhöz ragadtabb most a Battle Royale terén. És ez nem rossz. Most a játékban milyen lesz, azt nem tudom a játékmenet, mert nem játszottam vele, de...
Far Cry Primal and multiple Prince of Persia titles has established him as a top creative here at Ubisoft.
For me, what's exciting is we started building it from scratch, seeing it grow, adding ideas...
Hát már a Matrixban vannak benne toxik.
Hello, contender. Welcome to the Hyperscape.
The game takes place in 2054. It's in a future where humanity has grown a little darker. One of the companies there, they are launching what's called the Hyperscape, which is a virtual world and the internet of the future. It's the place where everything converges. Within the virtual world, there is a battle royale. That...
Miért tölt fel a sem?
Then we also introduce a lot of
nem tudom, Brian, jelentkeztem rá, de nem kaptam hozzáférést. De reménykedem benne, hogy a következő viszont kapok. Nálam van a probléma? Tuti, nálam a probléma. Bocs, chat, nálam a probléma, tuti. Azért frissítek rajta, jó? Bocsi. Nálam töltik a keske pornót. Ez maga a Matrix szimuláció annyiból különbözik tényleg a másiktól, hogy most a szülyé jön le, de jobban magadnak érezheted, mert ehhez azért közelebb vagyunk a virtuális Battle Royale-hoz. Van is egy ilyen játék amúgy, hogy Battle Royale PC-re és VR-os. Mi az van? Mit tölteszem?
Interact with the game on different levels through the Twitch extension.
Mit spoilerezel? Nálam tölt folyamatosan, srácok, nálam tört, már haladodik a Twitch is, minden haladodik.
Hihető.
Jobban tudsz fel azonosulni ilyen téren. Na jó, nem tudom, mi fasz van. Nálam folyamatosan tölt, srácok.
And so it's gonna be available for free to play for all PC players worldwide. I really want to thank all the players, all the streamers.
Nem tudtam, folyamatosan próbáltam belépni UP-be, nem enged, még mindig. Ledobja az accountom.
Of what you can expect.
Nem tudok belépni. Zárd be a pont.
Watch and learn how it's done. Perfecto. Showtime.
Bezárom a... Kilcsap. Szújrainítom ezt a részt. Ráfrissítek az egészre a picsába, aztán úgy hát, ha jobb lesz. Bezárom a Ubisoftot is, mert lehet, hogy ott rosszalkodott maga a rendszer. Ahogy le volt, hogy jó a hang, ezt nem is láttam. Lol. Nálam miért tölti? Hát nem is értem. Bocs, chat, nálam van a probléma, tuti, de
developers incredible.
Nálam most tölti. Átmények YouTube-ra, bocs, srácok, de nálam most töltötte folyamatosan a Twitch. És nem is tudom miért. Pillanat.
He switched different outfits, different fashion statements, different tattoos, different materials until we see them as real individuals, as real people. So the second you pick a character, you see them in game, you understand what their motivations are, what drives them, what challenges them.
Újra kell tenni az egész gépet,
this was
gyerekek.
The first lineup of characters. This is our default base, but even starting from the hair down, everything has been meticulously thought of.
Nálam szor az egész.
This person actually liked this type of outfit. Would this person enjoy the type of tattoos that we're putting on them? Will they actually like to be in this body? Each season, we plan to produce new outfits for these characters. So we're hoping some of our players are gonna see the effort and maybe even correlate some of the accessories to.
Én remélem, azt nem cseszik el azokkal a skinekkel, mint ami a Fortnite-ban is volt. In people's hands.
As we move into the next generation of gaming, Ubisoft has been working closely with console makers to take advantage of all the extraordinary capabilities these new consoles will offer.
Now we have a special guest to tell us a little more.
Hey everyone, Phil Spencer from Xbox. With Watch Dogs Legion, Ubisoft is supporting smart delivery.
Ez so you get the absolute best version of the game
on any version of Xbox you're playing on.
Egyértelmű.
On Series X, you'll get to take advantage of the amazing work the team has done with DirectX ray tracing to create an absolutely immersive version of London like you've never seen before.
Oh,
Ubisoft has a unique ability to create immersive worlds, setting a new bar that continues to drive our industry forward. I'm a huge fan of Assassin's Creed. I love the time I've spent exploring the world in Assassin's Creed Odyssey. And I can't wait for you to see the gameplay from Assassin's Creed Valhalla that's coming up now.
Motion.
All right. We know you've been waiting to hear more about this game since it was announced back in April. And now it's time for a deep dive into the world of Vikings.
My name is Julien Laferrière, and I'm the producer of Assassin's Creed Valhalla. So a couple of weeks ago, we announced Assassin's Creed Valhalla, and the reaction from the fans was just amazing. The time period of Vikings is really, really inspiring. When we did our research, we found that, you know, they were not mindless barbarians. Vikings were actually farmers trying to find new lands for them to settle. And so they had really human motivations. So for us to have this opportunity to tell kind of the real story about Vikings and kind of separate ourselves from the myths and the folklore is really something that drove us to make this game. The team went to Norway and England to take the same roads that the Vikings did, to really experience what it meant to be a Viking at that time.
Norway, which
is barren but majestic, and just coming by boat in England and see those rolling green hills full of sheep, full of life.
It's just this November moment that Valhalla megjelenés.
Most likely the Vikings felt as well. You need to see this land of opportunity. And this is exactly the feeling we want players to experience in this game.
November közepe, én is úgy.
It is a personal adventure. You know, it is the story of Eivor, a Viking chieftain. Eivor is either a male or a female. You decide when you start the game. they will have to leave Norway to settle in England because you just can't live in Norway anymore. There's too much political pressure, no resources available. Obviously, in England, it's full of Anglo-Saxons and other people, and they don't really want you there. So you will have to fight your way there to kind of build your own settlement and see your clan prosper. Vikings were brutal warriors.
Shields!
And the fact that they were mastering a lot of weapons coming from the medieval times really inspired us to kind of revamp the fight system. To leverage the brutality and the intensity of Viking combat. Vikings were not only fighting face to face, they were masters of stealth and deception when needed. They used basically any sort of tactics they could use to win the battle. So we want to portray the full range of combat that you can imagine coming from the Vikings. We are very happy to finally be able to show you the game we've all been working on. So please enjoy this deep dive into Assassin's Creed Valhalla.
Na, elvileg így fog kinézni. Work in progress.
In Assassin's Creed Valhalla, you will relive the epic saga of the Viking invasion of England. You play as Eivor, a Viking from Norway, who will lead his or her battle-hardened warriors across the North Sea to the British Isles. Eivor is driven by an ambitious goal, to build a thriving Norse settlement in a hostile land.
For the good of our clan, it is time we go a Viking. Today we raid, that tomorrow we may build.
Eivor, yeah, huh?
England is a dark age tangle of broken kingdoms and warring dynasties. A land of opportunity and riches. As you prowl England's rivers by longship, you may raid locations you spot from the shoreline. Ground your ship and blow your horn to lead your raiding crew into battle.
Revive me?
Your crew will assist you in all your raids, fighting enemies, battering down doors, and stealing cargo too heavy for one set of arms. Whatever riches and resources you pillage may be used to develop your settlement, giving you access to useful services, better tools.
Igen, ez az építkezéses dologban eléggé új dolog lesz teljes mértékben.
It will serve as a record of the allies you have made and a guide for future opportunities. The Viking Age was a time of warriors and legends. In Valhalla, you will find the largest variety of enemies ever assembled in an Assassin's Creed game.
Ebben nagyobb harcok lesznek szerintem. Az igen. Különböző enemi, különböző harcstílusok.
Some will coordinate with their allies for special attacks, while others will use nearby objects to their advantage, including the bodies of fallen warriors. To face these attacks, you must find and exploit your opponent's weaknesses to gain the upper hand. Take the fight to your foes with a host of brutal new combat abilities. Snare them with a Viking harpoon.
Oh.
Pummel them with throwing axes.
Az igen.
Incapacitate them with the new stun system to keep them at a distance. Or finish them off.
Jók a finishek benne.
You'll wield any two weapons you wish to unleash a deadly combination of attacks. Customize your fighting style as you see fit, and become a legendary Viking warrior.
Jó a zene.
All combinations of weapons are available to dual wield, including two shields.
Get out.
Not all situations call for violence. In this new land, a Viking must find a way to adapt. As Eivor is not welcome in England,
mondtam, hogy you may need to have a smart enemies,
avoiding unwanted attention in town.
Emiatt nem kell aggódni.
Use Eivor's hood and cloak to blend with crowds.
De komoly.
And slip past watchful eyes. An unseen hunter among the people.
Sokkal kiforradtabb a lopakodás benne.
Exploration is vital to keeping yourself sharp. You must feed off the land if you hope to endure. Hunt and forage to replenish your health and fortify your
equipment. Hát gyerekek! Hát gyerekek! Instant 200 óra.
And Roman ruins for new activities and challenges to strengthen yourself and your settlement.
És vannak benne kis puzzle-ok is, ahogy látom.
The more you explore, the more of England's secrets you will reveal.
Ravens, show no mercy!
But as you push deeper into England, the enemy will push back.
Jézusom, de menő.
A series of climactic moments. Assassin's Creed Valhalla will feature
ezeket annyira hiányoltam. Ezeket annyira hiányoltam, gyerekek.
Today we will reclaim her. Today we fight for your land. And
kicsit a Forerunnerből szerintem hozták ezeket, és így belevitték a játékba, nagyon jó.
Assassin's Creed Valhalla will transport you to wondrous and haunted lands, inspired by Norse myths and England's pagan roots. It will challenge and surprise.
Thank you, man.
With unforgettable characters, thrilling triumphs, and tragic losses, giving you the chance to live your own Viking saga.
Megjelenés. November 17, ott van. November 17, tessék.
9th century England is truly unlike anything the franchise has seen before.
November 17,
Assassin's Creed Valhalla will release this holiday season on Xbox Series X, PlayStation 5, Xbox One, PS4, PC, and Stadia.
Király.
We're close to wrapping up today, but before we go, our CEO, Yves Guillemot, is here to share a few words.
I hope you will have enjoyed what you have seen today and that you will love playing these games. I'm proud of our teams for delivering an ambitious, broad, and creative lineup of games. And we haven't shown you everything yet. In fact, we have a lot more to come. So you will have another Ubisoft Forward to reveal even more about our upcoming games. But before ending this show, we have one more thing to share with you.
No. Far Cry. Far Cry, nem? Erről már volt szivárogtatás Twitteren is. Nem tudom, mire számít csak ilyen téren már. Live action trailer.
It's beautiful, Milo. Perfect, but useless. I have something for you, Diego. Give me your hands.
A kis Diego.
The grenade is simple.
It has four bases. Tehát ez most...
The shell, which contains the explosive.
Ez a CGI, vagy nem?
The handle, and of course, the pin.
Olyan fura a gyereknek az arc, látod?
What are you doing?
Breathe, Diego. Breathe. The pin simply holds the handle in place.
Meg nem mondtam az elején.
It is only when you let go that this grenade goes boom. Follow me.
Az igen.
Now.
Séta, csak el ne engedd.
I am El Presidente, which means that someday you will be El Presidente. And our people, they do not know how
to be happy.
They are torn apart by opinions, noise, indecision, strangled by their own freedoms. And even if you have love in your heart, even if you want what's best for them, if you only want to save them from themselves. They will hate you, Diego. Everything you say, do, believe, will be wrong.
Hát éppen az ő hatalmát döntik meg most éppen, nem?
They will answer you with screams. Call you evil. Monster, and give you this.
Muerte.
So you tell me, are you evil? Are you a monster? Because our country is like this grenade, except it has two basic parts. Our people. And you must clutch them nice and tight, or we all go boom.
Február 18, gyerekek. Sok minden nem derült ki belőle, de kíváncsi leszek.
And with that, we're wrapping up our first Ubisoft Forward. Today, we've seen the next generation of Assassin's Creed, the birth of a resistance in Watch Dogs Legion, the cyber chaos of
Azért kapunk.
And the epic reveal of Far Cry's newest installment, along with so much more.
Remember, we'll be back later this year with another Ubisoft Forward filled with tons of game news and updates.
Thanks for joining us.
Hmm. kapcsán plusz 18-as lesz a game.
Hey everyone, welcome to the Ubisoft Forward post show. My name is Yusuf McGeed and this is Assassin's Creed Valhalla. We're going to take a deep dive into about 30 minutes of gameplay and we're joined by a very special guest here.
Hey everyone, this is Philippe Bergeron, otherwise known as Fizz. I am the quest director on Assassin's Creed Valhalla.
So Fizz, we're setting up here for what looks like an epic encounter. Tell us exactly what's going on here.
Yeah, so here we're midway through the quest that we're showing for you before. Here we're looking at the assault of Burg Castle. So these are big moments that usually sort of culminate at the end of the story. And so here Eivor, our Viking Raider, is taking
a group of raiders
into Burg Castle to go and take down Ruid and his clan.
So who exactly is Ruid and why does Eivor sort of want to pick a fight with him?
Basically, Ruid comes into play about halfway through this story arc, where at the beginning of the arc, this is something that happens before, Ruid basically caused a lot of turmoil within the territory, and Oswald, who's the sort of elderman to be to inherit this territory, needs your help to take him down. Oswald having just been defeated in a previous quest, and so here this is revenge, but also accomplishing your ultimate goal.
So Fizz, as you're talking, we're seeing some of the combat of Valhalla. Can you tell us a little bit about the changes to combat this time around?
We
wanted to basically add a lot of new mechanics to it. So we added like some dual wielding for the player, like a stun system in there. And we really needed to do this to sort of portray that sort of the brutality that comes with being a Viking in this day and age. So it sort of fits into that the time and the character.
Ő is rendeltem, azt hiszem valami extra kiadást süti. Hol tetszett?
He lives. Oswald lives!
Eivor, is that you?
Shut your ass, twig spine.
Here, Eivor has taken her entire army through the assault, and finally, it's revealed that our elderman, our ally, Oswald, is still alive, and Ruid has him captive.
So this is what it comes to, Wolfkist? Two Danes fighting over a filthy Saxon whore, son? If this swine is your prize, come and get him!
So now that we've seen that Oswald is alive, we have Ruid within our sights. What's the next step here?
So the next move for Eivor is to finally face off against Ruid. She has her allies, they can take care of the rest of the army. Now it's time to go one-on-one against Ruid. One of our boss battles, actually.
Your battle is not yet won, Oswald.
And it's worth pointing out, actually, that here what we're showing is the player going and facing off against Ruid aggressively, but we tend to always have to support a 360-degree approach in these things. So the player could have approached us a little bit more stealthily and gotten at least like a good critical hit on either Ruid or his wolf, and so you can play this a little bit more strategically if that's your playstyle.
So we're not only fighting Ruid here, but also his pet wolf, right?
One of my preferred strategies is to eliminate the wolf first, just focus fire on him. It takes at least one opponent out of the combat. Now, Ruid will have extra abilities that come into play if you do eliminate his wolf, but I think having one opponent less in the battlefield makes for a good strategy in the whole.
Yeah, most az enemynek mondtam, mert neki van egy hosszabb, meg van két fel darabolt sávja, azt nem tudom, hol tenni hirtelen. Az is hír.
Valhalla is my destiny. That thing will not be met today.
Why does this stamina piece Dark Soul-os? Aha. Igen, Toxic, kicsit Souls-style-os a rendszer, de ez már a csúnyán fejezet. Nem játszottam olyan ilyen játékokat, de már látszik azért az Odyssey. Itt meg szerintem még jobban elmenek erre. Még nehezebb lesz a játék. Ez nem feltétlen gond.
He should be tried before God, a lawful assembly.
All right, so we've defeated Ruid, we freed Oswald. What comes next?
Oswald in this case prefers for Ruid to be kept alive, and so you basically have to choose, are you going to go against his witches or stay true to your nature?
So we have this choice to make, but before we get into that, I want to rewind a little bit because we just did this big, grand assault, but Eivor couldn't have done it alone. She clearly had to recruit some folks along the way, get some troops, get some allies. So let's actually rewind and see how we went about first gathering those troops.
Right, so when coming up to an assault, it's a game of numbers. Eivor can go into pretty much any location and be a stealthy Viking, eliminating some of the assets, which ultimately would be a strategy. You can do that, and you'll have some of the ingredients or of the assets there that will have been sabotaged, but you still need an army. So here what we're seeing is Eivor going around the countryside and raising what we call the men and the women of the territory who come up and fight in the name of a king. So here Eivor is going around and trying to convince people to fight in the name of Oswald to finally take down the oppressor that is Ruid.
Defending East Anglia, defending you. Will you not do the same?
What? In defense of a last cause.
Yeah, so she's really using the image and the leadership that Oswald had, what he meant to the people in his name. She's going to recruit these people.
Pretty words, Dane, but the men of Theovard have their own battles to fight.
So we're told by this Reeve that there are troops, there are allies that he could add to our cause. But first, we sort of need to do him a favor. Is that right?
Yeah, so obviously these people have been run down by Ruid and the impact he's had on the territory. So I think a lot of these people have sort of lost hope. And so you need to show them that there is hope. And so here, Eivor is basically helping them take back one of their prized locations by taking a couple men and raiding a nearby township. Basically taking it back.
Vagy ha már grafikában ugyanazt a szintet hozza, mint az Odyssey, akkor nem lesz probléma, és az a minimum szint szerintem ez volt. Egyedül, amit remélem, hogy javítanak, az az alaplap proci terhelés, mert azért az elég kemény volt. Még most is eszi a procit az Odyssey. Meg hát ezek a zenék, ezt halljátok félig meddig.
When Eivor does this, obviously you have access to a full suite of abilities. So again, the improvements that we've done to the fight system, you have some brutal axe throwing in there. You have archery really, again, depending on what your playstyle is, you can customize your loadout and go in there how you wish.
Fizz, we just saw this giant pulse go out. What exactly was that?
So that is actually what we call the Odin Sight. The Odin Sight is basically our interpretation of the Eagle Vision from previous games. And we thought it was good to sort of bring that back. Mm-hmm. It's basically Eivor's intuition. It's how she perceives the world. When player uses that, you can, it'll highlight basically interactive objects, like things that will bring her an advantage. So we'll have arrows, like health consumables that are in there. So it really is like a good way of sort of understanding the world and showing you like things that you can go and touch.
Yeah, I mean, speaking of things we can touch, we just picked up this awesome new weapon.
It's something we wanted to play with on Assassin's Creed Valhalla, where we have fewer weapons in the game, but you can invest in them more. So they become your weapons. And so depending on what your preferred playstyle is, or your preferred weapon type, then you can go and choose. I'm gonna fight with this weapon and invest heavily into that.
Not only are we looting weapons, but we see something here called the Book of Knowledge. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
We have these spread out throughout the world, so again, to promote exploration and discovery. As you travel through the world and you explore locations, you can find these books that will add abilities that you can go and invest in, put into your loadout, then go into the different locations or the different quests in the game and use those depending on what your playstyle is.
Now we've recaptured this village, we've secured more troops for our assault. Let's jump back now and figure out what we want to do with Ruid.
Nem mutatja, mi történik.
The rightful king of East Anglia has spared your life today, and so it will be.
Compassion is a virtue suited for anyone, Eivor. Including you. Thank you.
Eivor decide to let him live. Ruud is really angry about that. Being a Norse Viking, being put to the death in battle is your road to Valhalla. So he was basically denied access to Valhalla in this situation. Obviously, all of these decisions come into play later on in the game, so we have very difficult decisions for the player to make. We didn't want to have easy decisions.
Yeah, you know, when I was playing, I decided to listen to Oswald and spare Ruud's life, but what exactly is the relationship
between Eivor and Oswald?
So the relationship between Eivor and Oswald is an alliance. It's basically Eivor is surrounded by territories that initially getting into England are hostile towards her. And obviously, if you want to set up a new settlement, you want to have make sure that your neighbor is friendly. So here in East Anglia, Oswald is the man for the job, where putting him into a position of power would help her sort of secure her territory. So earlier on to the territory, Eivor comes in here, meets Oswald. The problems he had with Ruud are sort of put to light, and going through the arc, you basically help him deal with Ruud and aligning basically Danes with Saxons in one territory.
So Fizz, we've completed the assault. We've gotten our hands dirty with some combat, taken down Ruud. We have this big open region of East Anglia, so before we head off to Oswald's wedding, what do you say we head out, have some fun, and see what we can get into in the open world?
That sounds great.
So we see a cat here with a speak bubble above it, and you best believe if you let me talk to a cat, I'm gonna talk to a cat.
Yeah, these are some of our some of my favorite moments actually in the game, where we put out a whole bunch of events throughout the territory. And it sort of rewards exploration, going around. It's a chance for us also to sort of showcase a different side of Eivor. A lot of the quests sort of deal more with like politics and warfare, and this shows a slightly more human nature to her. So it permits us to explore that character a little bit more. So here, basically, like you're trying to help a kid with his cat, and ultimately get that cat to sort of join your crew as a cat raider.
You just said cat raider way too casually. You're telling me I could have a cat Viking raider on my longship?
That's exactly what I'm telling you.
Oh my god, yes, I love it.
Jesus, Sean.
So, as you're riding around the rivers of England, you would see a cat basically walking around your longship, keeping your Viking raiders company.
You know, speaking of the Viking longship, we're seeing some of that gameplay here now. Can you talk a little bit about how that works and functions in Valhalla?
So starting out on this project, I think the Viking longship is one of the biggest images that we all have when we think about Vikings in our game. And so Vikings had this awesome design for longship that had a very shallow hull, so it permitted them to go very far inland very quickly, and you could basically disembark Viking raiders like on pretty much any shore. We added that into the game, where you can basically sail up to any location and then just decide to disembark with your guys and raid a location, loot all his treasure, get back in the ship, and then continue sailing down the river.
So I know past Assassin's Creed games allowed for songs and things like that to be sung on ships. Will Valhalla have a similar version of that?
Yeah, so this is something we actually wanted the crew of your ship to become like your home away from home. So we added stories and songs into the ship. So basically, as the player is going around, you could decide to have your skald sort of sing a song for you as you row down the river. But you can also decide, depending on who the raiders are in your ship, to hear more about their life. So you can actually queue up stories, and they'll give you a little bit more background on who they are. So you get to know your sort of fighters as you're traveling around the world, which is a cool moment.
So here we're seeing a bit of a different view. What exactly are we looking at?
We had this on previous Assassins, where you would like ride on your horse and you could pull out, have the horse sort of follow the track. We have a similar thing for the ship, where you can put up your sails. It's cruise control for the ship, so you can pull back, take in the scenery, listen to some songs or some stories, and just take it all in.
So, you know, speaking of Viking songs, we have an activity here that's not exactly singing, but kind of related, right?
Yeah, so here what we have is what we call flighting, which was an activity that Norse people would partake in. They would like to have a battle of wits and sort of poetry, where insults would be thrown back and forth between each other. The idea was to try and have a good insult,
but also to
have a good rhythm and a good rhyme in there. So it's basically a precursor to rap battles.
Here's the silver. Now begin.
To all those whom I speak, they say Eivor's a clod.
Then you're speaking to fools and their knowledge is flawed.
Well,
how exactly do you go about being successful?
The trick behind a good flight was to choose the right insult, identifying the right cadence, and then trying to find what rhymed the best.
I'm known for my might.
Interesting. Silent whispers all claim that you're terribly dense.
Viszészed, Bence. Megvevős lesz.
Then you've clearly misheard them. My wit is immense.
Nem mozgott a szája, nem mozgott a
szája. Well, what a surprise!
Jó, hát novemberig ezt még ki tudják javítani.
Van
még 4 hónapig.
Don't believe everything you hear, unless it touches on my
lighting. És megjelenik a játék. 4 hónap.
So now that we've proven our sharp tongue and wit, I think it's time for a bit more relaxing activity.
Van 4 hónapon befejezni az Odisszét.
Yeah, that's it. So we gave Eivor a fishing line, so you can actually throw out a line and go catch some fish. This is used basically to play into our new health loop, where the player will lose health in the
world, and
it doesn't automatically regenerate like we would have in the past. So you actually have to go out and get some supplies. So you'll find mushrooms and some food that you can gather. But here, like you can also catch some fish and consume that to regain some health.
We also
sometimes have it in certain quests. So it's a good way to sort of chill out on the side of the water and just again take it all in.
Hát, a Cyberpunk mikor jelenik meg, srácok? Amúgy ez elég szívás így, mert Cyberpunk 100 óra, valahol a 200 óra,
find these around the world,
nem az.
And you make offerings to it, so it'll take like animal parts and stuff that you can find throughout the world. Here what you're seeing though is sort of like a fancy version of it, where as you do your offering you get interrupted by some kids that basically come and steal your stuff. So it's just a way for us to sort of showcase that, like the systems and activities that we can sort of play in with some quests and some little events. So
annyi előnyünk lesz, hogy a Basso Edition-t veszük meg az AC-ból, akkor ha úgy lesz, mint az Odyssey-nél, meg az Origins-nél, akkor 3 nappal hamarabb játszhatunk vele. Szóval akkor lehet, hogy már 14-én tudok vele játszani, majd a Valhallával, és az jó lenne. Az a 3 nap a sokat
hamarabb. Because you can imagine at some point that we'll grow old if you're always telling that version of the character. So it lets us really go into the depth of who is Eivor, what motivates her, how she can interact with the world outside of warfare and politics.
Az a baj, hogy mindkét játék akkora volumenű, de nem lehet egyszerre kettőre figyelni, nem tudom,
túl nagy játék mindkettő. So it just widens the breadth of the stories that we can tell.
So who exactly are these 2 children?
These are kids of East Anglia. They are going through tough times with whatever Ruud's been doing to the territory. And so they're just here trying to survive and
basically exploit
the people that are there to make offerings.
It was kind of nice to see that Eivor wasn't really necessarily upset at them for stealing, and you know, after you talk to them, you have the choice of helping them. You can, you know, give them food, give them some money, or you know, maybe just say, "Hey, good luck, on your way."
Yeah, and then this is something we also wanted to do a lot. Like, so here we're doing an event, we do it in quests as well, but we want to give a lot of this agency into players' hands so that they can sort of shape Eivor a little bit. Who she is, or it represents them a little bit more, and they can role play that a little bit better. And again, it just gives her like a little bit more humanity in these moments.
Provide for small walkers. Here, large walker.
Nálam nem marugva a szíj.
Yes, it's a Saint Martin seal.
You're welcome here anytime, Large Walker.
Chat.
You're one of us now.
Nézzétek meg a következő számomat.
I will. Take care now, small green walkers.
Jozza, mi lett? Ja, törölték a botot? Akkor örülök neki, csak azért, mert 15.300 követőm volt, most meg 14.000.
Yeah, so here you're seeing Eivor running down one of our tattoo images. So this is challenging the player on free run abilities, but also for fans of the series, sort of pulling at their heartstrings for some beloved features.
So
are we going to be able to tattoo Eivor?
Yes, by collecting these tattoos, you actually bring them to, back to your settlement, and then you can customize different body parts, having different tattoos everywhere. So again, another form of expression, and
meg
sort of
a
to represent that Viking culture.
Behalt a gépem, a Steam gépem.
One of my favorite things when I was just out there exploring East Anglia was coming upon a house or a building, and realizing that there was a chest inside,
nem tudom,
but
mi lehet.
There was no
nálam
easy way in. And in this case, I saw all the doors were barred, but I knew that because there was a chest in there, there must have been some way to get inside. So
a
I went around the back
nézni,
and,
tört.
You know, found a way in.
Nem tudom, mi van.
Yeah, I'm glad you actually caught on to that. You're pointing at something that we wanted to work on a lot on Valhalla, where we wanted the exploration to make you feel smarter, so we played a lot with puzzle solving, so making sure that every house that you find sort of appeals to you, like it draws your attention, and then when you want to come and explore, it's not given to you. You still have to work for it a little bit, so it'll challenge you on your observation skills, logic, just trying to find how do I get into this. So we play a lot with level design, quest design, to offer challenges to players and basically come out of it like feeling for the exploration, but you also get to see more of a story behind any of these locations which we've crafted, so it gave us a little bit more time to sort of slow down the experience and tell a different version of a story.
Vajon miért? Majdnem egy millióan nézik a special events-et, fél millióan nézik az félmillió általános csevegés van. A Jubi az kicsinálja most a Twitch-et is, mert
yeah, I mean, speaking
mindent.
About exploration and just finding things out in the world, I was just wandering and came across this clearing and found this.
Nem értem, miért nincsenek erre felkészülve. Hogy
yeah,
néz ki?
Yeah, so this is one of our bigger events that we have scattered in the world. So as Eivor explores, she can find altars like this and
jó, mert én is köszönjük, itt voltál, köszönjük, vigyázz magad a jó munkát holnap, kitartást, ügyesen, csaposan, nyomassan neki is. Köszönjük, itt voltál még
egyszer. Köszi a helpet. Steps to it later on. So this is one of the moments. It permits us to go into a slightly more
mystical realm. Kicsit lejjebb veszem, hanem baj, hogy ne beszél már ilyen sokat. Figyelj már, chat. Ebben is vannak ilyen nagyon-nagyon-nagyon-nagyon-nagyon és nagy istenek, mint az Origins-ben vagy az Odyssey-ben.
Reagan using like are a little bit on the mystical side of things. What's happening is Eivor at the beginning in that trap is poison, and so she starts sort of hallucinating, seeing the world in a sort of different light and filter.
Mármint úgy megjelenve. Mert oké, hogy vannak nagy istenség, és az oké, csak hogy így. Most csak ilyen kis boss fightot kapunk, mert tudom, hogy ez kiszivárgott ez a boss fight Regannál, de ezen felül. Azért, mert nincs valamilyen infók ezekről. Elhinthetnének egy kis istenséges fightot, vagy valamit. Odin a főisten, azt várom.
So we just saw here that Regan belongs to something called the Daughters of Lyria.
Yeah, that's correct.
By finding the other daughters, you'll get a little bit more backstory on who they are, so we don't want to spoil that too much.
Aki szürke szíves, olyan hülyén néz ki, olyan buta. De ez még szerintem nem a végleges verzió. És mondták is, nem a végleges verzió, azt tudja, hogy mondják majd, hogy figyelme az a szíveske, az szürkébe lent, az úgy.
So we just had a really exciting, really intense boss battle. I think it's time for something a little bit more relaxing and calming.
Szándékosan szivárogtatnak. Szerintem nem tanultak a Crysis hibájából.
So here we have a low chill moment of what we call building a cairn. So Eivor, as she explores the world, will find these sort of meditative areas where you have a pile of rocks that you could just stack on one on top of another using physics. And I mean, yeah, the ultimate goal is to try and get the highest pile of rocks, but really it's about taking in the sights, relaxing, taking a step back, and just building something.
Together we stack stones into cairns.
Ez kb. Ugyanaz, mint volt az Originsben.
Yes.
A csillagos rész, ugye? Az, hogy le fog borulni.
I mean, you can spend as much time as you want building these things, making them as high as you want, as weird as you want. I'm sure, like, a lot of these stuff will end up on the internet, like people comparing structures. And the cool thing is that once you've built it and you decide to get out of it, it sort of stays there. And so that's yours, right? And until the moment where you come back and you want to build a new one, it's sort of cool that we're able to give that to players to express themselves.
At this point in the demo, we've explored East Anglia, we've met some children.
Most azért látjátok a magasságot a hátterül, azért lehetett látni, hogy voltak szintek.
I think now it's finally time to go and head off to Oswald's wedding.
Yeah, so this is the moment it's all been building up to.
By
the moment you get into the territory, sort of like mentioned by Oswald, that he's trying to get married with his Dane lady. And so as you go through the arc, that's sort of like the underlying thread. Really, it's about Ruud creating turmoil in the territory and helping Oswald sort of get above that and show that he's a good leader. And so you finally, after going through all of that arc, finally get these two together, go through their wedding, and you're invited to attend the ceremony. And then all the activities and fun times that comes afterwards.
Ideig nem dobtam hátast, amúgy már mint jó, de az Odysseus számomra sokkal sokszínűbb és szimpatikusabb. Ricsi, tehát ne hidd azt, tehát mondom, már, hogy is mondjam, a Ubisoft azért már ők is játszanak egy ilyen kis adok-kapok dolgot, és nehogy azt hitt, hogy most lelőnek mindent. Mondta, hogy lesz még egy event, ott is fognak puzzle-okat mutatni, ez még nem a végleges verzió, sőt, ez szerintem még a, lehet, hogy fél évvel ezelőtti verzió, amit most látunk, azóta teljesen nagyon sok minden változtatott azóta. Tökömet rá, hogy ez a verzió az már fél éves. Abszolút, nagyon sok minden, nagyon sok rétület, és nem fogják lelőni így a poént, az biztos. Lesznek itt még azért nagy újítások, és már ebben is lehet látni, hogy mennyi mindenben újult két év alatt is a játék. Hát... Várható volt, hogy meghal minden. A YouTube, a Twitch, a Uplay szerverek. Várható volt, hogy halál lesz, gyerekek, mert várható volt.
So here we see the decision I made to spare Ruud came back to bite us.
Yep, that's the decision you made, coming back. So
nézz vissza egy Odyssey szivárgást. Nézz vissza egy Odyssey bétát, hogy nézett ki, ha még fent vannak. És nézd meg most, hogy néz ki. Tehát én múltkor ezt csináltam. Volt különbség.
Yeah, you know, personally, I chose to fight myself because I thought Eivor.
Az Odyssey, vagy az Origins, vagy az Odyssey alapját azt megtartották. Egy picit még most rizikós ez a telep, ahol még viszik tovább a harcrendszert, hogy változtatnak rajta, amit láthattuk. És még nagy, meg ez az építkezés, ez a építs meg a saját faludat. Nagyon sok minden lesz benne, újítás. Ennél csak jobb lesz, igen, ennél csak jobb lesz. De már, én már erre is azt mondanám, hogy nekem ez így is jó. De így ide kell sokkal jobb lesz.
His big gun abilities like fairly earlier on in the fight. So it's way more vicious, way faster. There's less strategy. He goes literally swords blazing at you. And so this is a fight to the death.
Mekkora kardja van már.
An And of course here, like, this is a decision you made to go and fight him, but there's multiple outcomes to this scenario. You could have let Oswald fight his own fight and prove basically his
station as the rightful leader. Deathwish témából, mert elvileg különböző tetoválásai is lehetnek majd a karakteren. Abból se kaptunk még semmit nagyon.
In all scenarios, you still have an alliance with Oswald. He's proven to be the right leader for this territory.
Szét lesz varatva a karakterünk. A bal karja az vég lesz varatva, ha lehet
ilyet.
And one day I will need you to make good on that alliance.
So we're about to take off from the wedding, but Eivor decides it's a good idea to check up on her friend Finnur.
Yeah, so Finnur is probably one of the more recurring characters in this arc. You get to meet him very early on. He's a very endearing character, sort of used to have a Viking life.
Volt valami mutatva térkép, egy nagyon picike, de az nem tudom, mi volt.
It's sort of like lights that fire back, and so he's willing to join you in your raiders.
You'll
encounter in the game, and you can sort of recruit, bring back home.
Nem világképet mutattak, de ilyen
join you on your adventures.
Térkép részlet, nem tudom, mi lehetett
az pontosan. Stories that we're telling you about, you get a little bit to know a little bit more about him. So again, it's a fun way to sort of discover more about these characters that you meet and bring him along for adventures.
Together. I'll gather my things.
Well, folks, we've come to the end of our Assassin's Creed Valhalla playthrough. Fizz, thank you so much for joining us. When and where can people
play?
Assassin's Creed Valhalla will be out on Xbox Series X and PlayStation 5 and is coming to Xbox One, PlayStation
4, magas
PC, and Stadia épület on November 17th.
Hát srácok, szerintem ez ennyi volt. Kapunk még valamit?
Hey everybody, thanks for joining us. My name is Eric Pope. I'm the senior community developer on Hyperscape.
Hi, I'm Graham Jennings. I'm the senior producer on Hyperscape. Hyperscape's now in its open beta phase, so you can go to Uplay and download it directly.
So a little while back, we recorded a match for you so we could walk through it moment to moment, explain what's going on throughout a match of Hyperscape. There's a lot going on with hacks, guns, the gameplay. So Graham and I are going to walk you through it right now, and I hope you'll enjoy.
Én ezt kipróbálnám, sőt, ki is próbálom.
So the start now, you'll see the insertion phase. There's the three of them in the squad, so they're trying to decide on where they want to go. It looks like Helios, which is one of the landmarks, is going to be one of the choices.
So all the places we're seeing on the map right now with like a name above it, that tends to be a
ilyen
higher
loot
area,
kapszula.
Would you say?
For one of the big yellow letter ones, like this is one of the landmarks. Landmarks tend to have a higher density and higher quality loot overall.
Which also means most people will be going there, so you might have
usually have a few more friends if you go to
hero landing.
So in this case though, he's gone outside and he's trying to supply crate. So he's time to loot these instead. So he's looking for both hacks and weapons.
Open beta,
right? So the looting phase, many folks will be familiar with, but in Hyperscape, you do have those supply crates that you may be lucky enough to find. And what's the deal with supply crates?
So supply crates are placed around the world. So you'll hear them and then you can go and find them. And then inside them, you'll find weapons and hacks. Usually, you find slightly better weapons and hacks within them. Here now, we've switched, so we're looking at Chimera instead. So he's in the landmark, he's in Helios now, and he's still in the looting phase. But as you can see from the red triangle up there, there's actually some friends or not friends in there with him just now.
Yeah, so the action gets started. Okay, right here.
Yeah, so he's one-on-one, he's going with the Mammoth Shotgun against someone who's using the heal hack at the minute, which is the red circle you can see. So that player's taking extra health at that point.
Which looks like it helped him hold his ground against that mammoth.
And I believe it helped him survive at that point. There seems to be a few other players in here just now. So the combat started and an elimination of the first kill.
Benne.
Oh no, so he's just been eliminated actually.
Yeah.
So he just, he's been eliminated and he's turned into an echo now. So he's going to wait for his friends to bring him back. So he's going to go to one of these restore points, which are basically places where someone else from another squad has been eliminated, and you can be restored and brought back.
Ugyanez szállal, azért mondom, hogy adok egy esélyt. Az Apex fél évig bírta.
You're not stuck watching a camera with someone.
Megnézzük,
inform your squad as to what's going on, and then you can call to be restored.
Nem tudom, most még milyen a Valorantnak az utórengései? Még tartja magát bőven, srácok?
So we can also see when you have a teammate who needs a revive, it's called out on your...
Yeah, the green icon you can see at the side is him calling for a revive.
Igen, volt ilyen.
So Mr. Gormley's busy eliminating other players, which will cause more revive points to appear as well.
Még tartja
magát. This guy's low on health, so I don't think he's going
to... Nem azt mondom, most volt, hát a PUBG az kuka, az elraktaknak meg van a kis közössége, a kódnak is már kezd kialakulni az a kis közössége. A Valorant az még bontogatja a szárnyait. Fortnite-t azt hagyjuk. De az jó, hogyha foglalkoznak ezekkel, mert az elhattal biztos, meg a kóddal ezekkel tudja, hogy foglalkoznak. Ez a két game-mel. A Valoranttal nem tudom most mennyi plusz content jött bele, vagy jön majd bele. Biztos, hogy lesz majd megújítás.
He's got to reloot and find new weapons again because when you are eliminated, you go back.
Valanci, úgy jó, ha van öt haverod és azokkal nyomod, amúgy meg 9 éveseket dob össze. Hát én úgy gondolom, Csivesztó, hogy tehát, amikor fellök egy streamet, akkor, hogyha Valorant van, akkor tudtok ti is jönni velem. Amúgy van. Tetszik ez a pályaszéteséses téma.
To bring players towards a smaller map into the center. So instead of having a, you know, a circle that shrinks, we've decided to actually dissolve the map.
And is it kind of the same? Will you always know which districts are decaying first?
You can see from the map when you bring it up what's going, and you'll also see the icon when he turns on the left hand side of the screen a second ago, which shows you where the safe area to go is. So at the top it will show you sector is closing, and then you've got the little icon of the person running with a distance against it. That tells you where to go to the next safe place.
Ja, már ajnákot kaptál tőlük, szegény.
So I see Mr. Gummy has pinged that spot to sort of regroup outside of the landmark.
We're going to take some height as well to start to be able to look for other players and to keep themselves a little bit safe.
So you've seen another player actually
starting to throw salvos at him.
Valakinek fekszik, valakinek nem, mindenkinek van egy kialakult stílusa, hogyha is mondja, meg kategória, ami tetszik neki. Félig meddig örülünk annak, hogy amiből válogattunk. Viszont én úgy érzem, hogy kezd ez a kis csap elkopni, majd a Battle Royale-os csap. Na most emlékeztetek, hogy 2018 óta csak úgy ömlenek a Battle Royale gémek, és én úgy érzem, hogy 21-re ez már nem
így.
Igen, ahogy Aruki is írja, hogy szerintem 2021-re már nem nagyon lesz Battle Royale. Váltás lesz, hogy mire, azt nem tudom. De váltás lesz. Mi volt? Battle Royale előtt mi volt? Van, jó a Dota, a LoL, jó azokat, én most is játszák persze, csak már nem olyan szinten. Kíváncsi leszek, hogy mi lesz a 21-től az újabb trend, mert most egy 3-4 évet lehúzott a Battle Royale, de...
It will go up in various
different levels. So
basically, just to loot up, to fuse up, you just need to find.
Viszont ennek a hagyományos multira lehet.
Yeah. So you see though on the left, when you see the other players' names, you can see that Mr. Gomi has two yellow weapons.
Hogyha jó megcsinált ezt a gémet, akkor le tud húzni vele, mit mondjuk nyárig, le tudja húzni a gémet, de nem hiszem már, hogy olyan hatalmas jövője lenne tényleg ezeknek a gémeknek. Ott van a kód, működik a multi, jó is, megcsinálja, de mégis multiba sokkal többet látok embereket, hogy sokkal többen multizak inkább, mint Battle Royale-oznak. Vagy valaki, mit tudom én, elmegy egy órát Battle Royale-ozni, aztán elmegy 3 órát multizni. Saját esetemben ugyanez van, most nem is fele-fele néha. Elmegyek szólóba Battle Royale-ozni, aztán amikor csapatni akarom így randomokkal, akkor multiba elmegyek, és akkor velük
tomatom.
Kéne már egy újján real-tornament. azért is adok esélyt, mert bármennyire is szeretem a kódot, egyszerűen felzabálja a gépem is élvezető minőségben, nem tudom játszani. Hát de számára a Valorant az nem, mert a Valorant az még emészhető minőségnek mondható. Nem zabálja fel a gép. Ó, kezd visszaállni a Twitch, most már kezd jó lenni a Twitch. Aha. Jó, oké. Most már mínusz 1 millió néző. Most már jobban bírja a Twitch-szeró. Most már nálam se tölti a live-ot. Eddig töltötte.
Swap back to Mr. Gomi, he's still rolling with the Skybreaker at this point.
Még megvan az UT 2046 CD-s dobozos verziója. Az jó is volt, az egyik kedvencem volt az UT. Még a Valhallának mínusz 1 millió körülbelül. Jó van, Kondik, köszi, hogy itt voltál, vigyázz magadra, jó pihenést, jó munkát holnapra, ügyesen. Délelőtt talk show, tudjátok? Hogy talkshow-ból mire váltunk át, azt még nem tudom, van pár ötlet, de délután szerintem Batman-t fogom befejezni, estére. A Batman Arkham City végigjátszás lesz befejező rész, aki arra kíváncsi. Aki arra kíváncsi, az új készüljön. Lesz még valami, vagy már csak a Hyperspace, Escape Space. Miért nem az a nem, hogy Hyperspace? I'm escape, mindegy. Hogy már csak ez lesz?
And that countdown that just finished was a health kit event. What does that mean? What are these events?
So basically in the top right now you'll see
22:45 lesz valami. Nem tudom.
This is said that this is the time left for the health kit event. Basically every match there will be cards played which change what happens in the match. So this was the health kit event. There's things like
load. Elérhető már holnap. Szia Bogi, szia. Szép estét, hölgyem.
Are these just random or are players triggering these events somehow?
So there's two different ways this happens. So there's a game master, Grace, who plays them in this case. Or if there's a streamer in the game, the streamers
get
the chance to vote for which one they want to see. So it'll pop up, there'll be three different options.
12 volt nálunk 8 óra.
So viewers are directly impacting the streamers.
That's through the Crowncast extension.
Through the Crowncast Twitch extension.
Gameplay deep dive, de hát ez már volt, nem?
So here you see that you got caught in the decay then and fell through the trying to move back in.
Igen. Spamálnak azok mindent.
So we're starting to get towards a smaller map size, so it's going to become chaotic shortly. And they're just on the edge of this landmark. Red Tiger, so they're heading up. Here you'll see the top
is
the
crown appears in 10 seconds.
So basically you have a crown that spawns in the wall. If a player grabs the
crown
and
manages to hold on to it for 45 seconds, you'll win that game
through what we call crown victory. The only downside to that is once you've picked up the crown, everyone can see where you are and everyone's gonna chip you.
So yeah, he's got the crown, the countdown is on. As soon as, if he were to get eliminated, it would drop and that countdown would go away, right?
Yes, and then whoever picks it up next, that person, the countdown will start again for them.
And that's only one of the two ways you can win a match in Hyperscape, right?
Yeah, you can win via the crown if you want to take it and maneuver. This is why you'll see the really high up to own
space.
Or you can eliminate all the other teams.
You could sneak around and grab that crown and survive.
Van infunk róla, hogy lesz bár.
If you use your hacks well and you use your movement and hide a lot, then yeah, you could possibly grab the crown, get to the end, and then win via a crown victory. Wow.
There it is.
És le is hozta. Megvan a korona.
All right, well, that was just one match of the frenetic fast-paced game Hyperscape that we are both very lucky to work on. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for watching UB Forward and this post show. As we mentioned before, the game's available right now in open beta on PC. Just go to Uplay to download it. And we're also thrilled to be taking part in a Twitch Rivals event with the information appearing magically on the screen below us. So Graham, thank you for your time.
Thank you, Eric.
How
is it? I don't teach Rivals. Hyperscape. Deb. Köszi. Ennyi? Hát köszi Workasoft, hát köszi Jubi. Köszi, hogy nézhettelek egy igazi úriember vagy. Most hát ennyi volt. Press F. Ezek szerint ennyi volt a vége. Yeah! Pillanat. Ha már úgyis meghalt, de nem, most már kezd visszaállni a rendszer, csak meghalt azért a YouTube, a Twitch, meg a pár dolog. Pár dolog azért meghalt elég rendesen. Jaj. Igen, nem úgy van az, mert kaptunk egy jó kis Far Cry 6-ot, egy jó kis Valhallát, egy jó kis Watch Dogs-ot, aztán volt itt még egy-két ilyen cafat, viszont mondták, hogy lesz még event ebben az évben, ami számomra azt jelenti, hogy a remény felcsillanhat, mert hogyha már februárban lesz a Far Cry 6-nak a megjelenése, akkor nem csak erre az évre terveznek a srácok, szóval már a jövő évből is kaptunk egy pickét, és lehetséges, hogy bejelentenek egyet, mit tudom én, nyár elejére, májusra, egy Beyond 2-t. Én örülnék neki. Ha összejön. Na mindegy, srácok, remélem, hogy tetszett ez a kis stream. Én mindig szeretem az ilyen Uplay-es témákat veletek megnézni, mert tényleg jók szoktak lenni. A végén hát mivel köszönhetnék el, mint egy jó kis AC-s Valhallás zenével. Szóval találkozunk, srácok, holnap reggel 9-kor, aki velem tart. Mindenki másnak jó pihenés, jó munkát, holnap vasárnap helyett hétfő, 13-a lesz, kitartás mindenkinek, srácok. Találkozunk reggel 9-kor. Köszönöm, hogy itt voltatok, köszönöm szépen a követéseket, a hostokat, a rédeket, a csíreket, a szubokat, mindent. És találkozunk reggel 9-kor. Na, jó éjszakát, srácok, találkozunk, szevasztok, jó hét, sziasztok, srácok.